You guys had ended up making your way to the tower. Originally, you were sentenced to death. You argued, and Alex revealed that he was from the Kren. And because of those pieces of information, they granted you at least the ability to answer some questions so that they could assess what they really wanted to do with you. Upon that assessment, they determined it may be a good idea, or really the best idea, because it can keep the three of you alive. They were going to give you guys the opportunity to try and do something that hadn't been done in a very, very long time, called a tri-bonding. And that was essentially so that Pi, your character, would be bound to two Kaidan, which were going to be Alex and Helen. And so you guys agreed to this because the alternative, or it was better than the alternative, which is death. So you began the ritual, and you went through this really bizarre place with three kind of stages. One, there was this lady, and she ended up giving you kind of a puzzle piece or a little small tower, and she, you know, talked about perspectives and how evil might be good, might not be good. You went to the next room. The theme is very much the same, playing a game with another guy. And in the last room, a wraith was summoned, the one that you guys had previously fought in the Tower of Fykir. And it turned out that Alex and the wraith had temporarily kind of swapped forms, and you guys had to discover. And it all came back to this matter of perspective kind of ideal. But before the wraith had been summoned, you were visited by a woman, or at least a voice of a woman. You did see her. And she was the girl that you had seen on the path, escorted by her kind of guardian, her Kaidan. She was the one that you guys had seen in the dream with the lightning and him, like, dying behind her and all this other really kind of crazy stuff. And she essentially kind of told you guys, you know, wanted to join Fykir instead of doing this. You'd be rewarded greatly. And instead of saying yes, you guys essentially Dennis said no, and she was like, okay, well then here you go, fight a wraith. So that was more or less how that ended. To your knowledge, you woke up and you heard a few words about how the binding was successful, and you know what this means, and then you kind of passed back out again. And that was essentially where we left off. So do you guys have any questions before we begin?
So me, Aeleas, and Helen we're gonna be out for, like, what'd you say, like 2 weeks or something?
It was a full 10-day. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So 10 days. Yeah. So, in the meantime, Maple and Almadar are put up in an inn nearby by the tower.
Oh, okay. Right. Okay.
They were brought into the dream because they were a manifestation of your mind, kind of thing. They weren't physically there, but they mentioned that. Well, they told you that at least things like that could occur during these dreams. So it's not completely out of the ordinary that they're no longer here. So anyways, you guys are still passed out at this point. Anything else?
No, sure. Look, Mabel and I had a few things we had to do in that 10 days while we're...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think...
Just provisions and whatnot.
Yeah, take care of, yeah. All right. So...
We need to go find some fancy houses and steal their silver.
Exactly. Yeah, we need to do some shopping. Bartering stuff.
All right.
Murder shopping? Is that stealing?
Yeah, and fishing. Remember? We said we were going to go fishing.
Yes. Yes.
I think the abbreviation for murder shopping is mopping, which is where the term came. No mopping. Awesome. Okay. In all seriousness, we will get to you guys' shopping needs in a second. Pythagoras and Aeleas. You are slowly coming to. Your eyes, you're finding it difficult to open your eyes. They're very, very heavy. The world around you is blurred. So you're essentially looking through very, very kind of a blurry mask at the moment.
I'm blind!
It's strange. Because it's strange, because when you had woken up immediately following the ritual, you didn't feel this way. It was kind of like you're awake, you heard these things, and then you fell back asleep. Now it's like you're really, really groggy. And as you're sort of coming to, your senses slowly return, and you can feel that you're still on like the cold stone floor. So clearly you haven't moved. You feel like you've got this massive headache. Then as your ears kind of retune to what's happening, you can hear, I wouldn't describe it as a whimper, but kind of a choked up near cry. And it's a female voice, and she says, I accept whatever fate is bestowed upon me. Onassia, may you accept my soul. And as your vision kind of comes to, face still on the floor, you see Helen, and she is on her knees. And the main Kai Dame that had kind of sentenced you to all this at first has his hand on her forehead. It says, may Onassia guide you to the light. And you see a glow come from his hand, and Helen falls to the floor. Silent. You can see him again, your vision slowly returning. You can see him look to both of you on the ground and say, they'll be waking soon. Put them somewhere so that I may have words. And you see some boots approach you. You are in now full control of your body, especially as soon as you hear that, you're kind of like, whoa, what the hell's going on? So you're able to do whatever you want at this point.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to jump right up and be like, holy fuck, what just happened? What? Helen! Did she respond?
No, she's still on the floor.
What did you do to her?
Before he answers that, are you doing anything? Or are you just still lying there? I can't hear you. No.
Nothing.
Okay. Well, you figure that out. Aeleas will stand up, he says, as well. He looks to you and says, well, the ritual was not a success, unfortunately.
The last thing I heard when I went under was it was the first time it's been a success in decades or something like that.
That's not possible. You haven't been awake since the beginning of the ritual. Regardless, it was a failure. And, as we discussed, our final law was that if this did not succeed, Helen would die. We just carried out her judgment.
How do you know it was a failure, though?
Try and use your magic. Do anything.
Okay, I'll try the light spell. I'm cured!
You could call it that. In a way, this had greater benefits than we could have imagined. Helen's loss of life is unfortunate, but it appears that the mark of the Kai Dame and of the Kai Dan have been completely erased from both of you. Convenient. We've never seen something like this happen before, but so it has. So, you're free to go. You have no more business with you.
But why did she die? Wasn't she freed of her magical, or sorry, her powers?
Yes, she was. But our laws are clear in that when this ritual's carried out, there a punishment has to be given. Her last punishment was her life to you. That was not given. Therefore, she gives her life to us.
I think that makes sense. And I fall asleep. Ah, well, I don't want to be bonded to a dog murderer anyway.
Yeah, fair point. Yeah,
okay. Yeah, she did kill your dog. On purpose. Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just to save your life. Come on.
Yeah, bitch. You know what? Fuck her. I'm going to wake up and kick her. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, no.
So who's all in this room with us? Sorry. There is the main guy who sentenced you guys originally. There is the Kai Dame that had asked you all the questions in the cells. He's just staying there silently. And there are two other Kai Dame, presumably Kai Dame in robes, standing there that you have not seen previously. And then each of them have a Kai Dan with them as well.
Okay, so I'm going to ask just to the general room if they know of any side effects from having this, whatever Helen did to me, done to a not Kai Dame, someone like me.
You mean someone that hasn't been trained to accept?
Yeah, like voices, things like that.
No.
Oh.
Though most don't survive the ritual. Now, the fact that you were already dead, it's a case we've never experienced before. At least not in my time.
So if I had questions about it, you guys probably couldn't answer what I saw, what happened when she performed that ritual?
You have voices in your head.
Something like that. They were also
voices.
They were also in our ritual. But you said we didn't wake up, so I don't know what's what now. Because we saw you guys say it was a success, clear as day, but you deny that.
Yes.
So I don't know.
Unfortunately, I don't have answers for you. And as far as we can tell, your ability as a Kai Dan has been stripped. And that is really what we care about. So no, I do not have answers for you. And unfortunately, there is really nothing that we can do for you.
Okay.
He says, I apologize to place further burden upon you, but I would ask that unless you have further questions, your business here is done. We will have a cart bring your friend, if he appears to be unconscious, down to the inn where your companions are staying, but we would ask you to come in, and we pray that this is the last time that we have an interaction.
Okay, I guess.
Yeah, well, you are a crit.
I am.
Can you blame them?
A couple armed guards come in. They don't look like they're Kai Dan or Kai Dame or anything else, and they're the ones going to try and pick them up. Cool. But you're waking up,
yeah.
Clearly fine. All right. So they like help you to your feet, but then after seeing that you're awake, they're just like, all right, clearly you don't need us. But the guards do stand there and say, says we are to escort you to the front gate. If you would follow us, we would greatly appreciate it.
I have a few questions, actually. If
you're... I'm sure I cannot answer them.
What about him? The guy with the scar on his face.
The guy with the scar on his face is now talking with the one who had asked you questions, but as soon as you ask that, he looks back to you. What questions do you have?
Just minor questions. Had a couple dreams, started remembering some things. Maybe I was editing some audio. It was really weird. Anyway, I remember a tanner that we ran into a while back. His name was Remmel. Does that name ring a bell at all?
Can't say it does, no.
He had a strange ability. He could basically come back from the dead. He hunts what I believe is a vampire. Have you ever heard of this organization?
I'm sorry, no, I haven't.
And I also have this ring that I've been carrying around since that time. It actually belonged to a vampire, and I show him the ring. He's like, anything you can tell me about this?
He looks at it. To clarify, this ring that you're handing him, is that the one that you got off the vampire that you killed at the farm?
I believe so. It was the one that Antimaeus put on his finger, and then he shook the mayor's hand, and then we found out the mayor was working for somebody.
Right. Okay. Yeah. He looks at it. Could you give me a charisma check, please, there, Pi?
Yay, my best one.
Oh, on that note, actually, too, one positive side effect of this ritual, your negative, like the what the Wraith had done to you previously and reduced your charisma score.
The disadvantage.
That's been reversed. Yeah, sorry, the disadvantage. That's awesome. Been reversed, so you no longer need to worry about that.
What about your main curse?
The one Come on, seriously?
I seriously just rolled a one.
What about the one where you got cursed by the Kryn? You still have that?
Cursed by the Kryn?
Yeah.
I don't know anything about that.
You and Antimate.
Wasn't that the...
And I'm not here. Oh, that... It's just...
Sorry, that might have been the charisma disadvantage. Yeah, that might have been. It was one of those two situations. But regardless, yeah, any current disadvantage or ailments you have upon your character that are not just obviously part of your normal character are essentially wiped away. You're also back up to full hit points as well, yes. Both of you guys. Yeah. Maple and... And Almagar, you'll be back up to full hit points as well if you're not already, with full hit dice as well, because it's been 10 days and you've been doing not a whole lot but resting. So, Sorry,
when you say full hit points, we're not talking about like back to my original amount. Just, I'm full health.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So he looks at the ring, inspects it for a moment. No. Doesn't look familiar to me. Puts out his hand to give it to you, but back to you.
And there was some trouble with wolves back at the town we're staying at for about a year. It seems to be around your region in the woods there. Do you know anything about that at all?
That was Aerodel, wasn't it?
Yeah, not Aerodel.
Chrome? No, not Chrome Mill.
One by Chrome.
Yeah, the one.
Umbermill.
Yes.
That's
yeah.
It.
Wolves are not an unnatural thing to find in the forests in this area. But you're saying there was an increased activity?
Yeah.
I will tell you this, that the forests recently have become significantly more dangerous. I don't know why, but perhaps it's tied to that.
And I remember you saying we should start somewhere else with our quests because we weren't ready for other ones. Is there any places we should start, in your opinion?
It's really up to you, but typically I'd suggest a large city. Seems to be tons of work there, so perhaps travel back to Erdal if you've been there before. It's a kind city.
Yeah, less welcome place. We might be wanted. There's a thing. Don't worry about it, but...
None of my concern, so I'm not worried, but I would suggest not sticking around in Aelioth. So, perhaps that city, there's Fellhorn to the east. Suggestion.
Fair enough. Well, we'll be on our way. Is there any way we could stop in town just to get some provisions before we go? We're running really low. We'll leave immediately after.
Of course, of course. Yeah, take the rest of the day. I mean, you can leave tomorrow. You don't need to be out of here immediately, but I would suggest just not lingering for too long. Okay. There are many, many shops. The Aelioth is a very large city, so you should be able to find whatever you're looking for.
Okay.
Right. If there's nothing else, I will...
Thanks for not killing us. I mean, that was nice of you. Right, Aeleas?
Nice. Yeah, thank you.
Okay. All right. With that, he leaves the room, as do the other Kaidame and the Kaidan. The one who would ask you questions quite frequently, just as they're leaving, he's the last one out, and he just kind of gives you a sort of an awkward nod, and then he also continues on out the doors.
I nod to him.
Yeah. All right, so the two guards are still there. Now, sir, if you don't mind, I would like to escort you to the front gate so that you may be on your way.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
I'll go with.
All right. The two guards take you through back to the gardens that you would walk through originally. Back out the front gate. outside into the large plaza, and then down the main path through the three gates. Each gate opens for you as they did previously. Doesn't seem there's a whole lot of traffic that comes up this path or in between the city and the tower. Not unexpected, obviously, but it seems particularly quiet and particularly dead today. You make your way down to the end of the path. The guards just give you kind of a head nod, and they head back up through the gates again. And you're left at kind of the edge of the cliff face at the beginning of the city.
All right, sweet.
At this point, I'll jump over to Maple and Almagar. So briefly before those events occurred, a messenger showed up at the inn with a note stating that he had no idea what contents the note contained. He was not meant to know, but it was definitely for you two. He was given a very specific description. So assuming you take the note.
We'll take that from him.
All right.
Yeah, I don't want the note. Just forget it.
All right. He just kind of bends or bows, hands out the note. As you grab it, he just says, thank you, and then backs up a few paces while still facing you, and then turns around and leaves out of the inn.
It's awkward.
Okay. Well, it's all sealed? Like, is it wax sealed, or is it...
Yeah, it's got a wax seal on it. And looking at the seal, it's got the shield with the lightning bolt on it.
Okay, well, crack that open and see what we got.
Okay. It doesn't have a whole lot of content. It's pretty straight to the point, and more or less what it says is the ritual has come to completion. Your companions survived. We are expelling them from the tower. Please collect them at the base of the tower around midday. And then it's signed at the bottom and stamped. And that is essentially it.
Who's it signed by?
It is signed by someone with the name Albrecht.
Shit, I should have asked their names. Instead of Scarface and fucking...
Hey, you.
Well, what time of day roughly is it now?
It was just before midday, so this arrived quite conveniently in the nick of time. In fact, perhaps the reason why the messenger was a little bit awkward was maybe he should have delivered this, like, several hours ago.
Fair enough.
Fucking asshole.
I'll just kind of smack Almagar and, like, okay, we gotta go pick up our companions. They made it.
Oh, good news. Good. I've been wanting to give Helen her ring back. So. since I'm not keeping it. It's her ring.
Yeah, they're getting expelled out of the building. So sounds like they just kind of got kicked out. I wonder what Pi said to them. She's probably gonna pick them up before we make more enemies.
Yeah, I'm gonna get a good laugh out of that.
All right, so... Oh, there we go, saying all right and so again. Gotta call that.
Like, totally.
Like, totally.
Just switch it up, say, so I'm all right.
So, all right.
Flawless.
You are leaving the inn, then, obviously, to go collect your comrades. Okay. You gather up your gear... leave the inn. The streets are quite busy today in Aeleoth. Midday, the last few days, has been pretty crazy. Whether or not the city's like this normally, you've never been here before, so it might be unclear, but so far, the time you've been here, this is just the way it seems to be. Lots of merchants lining almost every street. Not quite getting to the point where they're begging you to buy their goods, but in many cases, they are. Or at least very close. A lot of them are claiming to sell, like, trinkets of the Kai Dame and things that were blessed by a Kai Dame, or this sword was wielded by some great Kaidan, and for only, you know, 3 gold, you can purchase it. And it's like, you know, a basic sword doesn't cost 3 gold. So it's, you know, you're not being duped too easily by this. But yeah, it's very much a kind of a merchant path. And then you arrive near the base of the tower, like obviously near the base of the first gate. And at this point, those merchants just kind of stop in a dead line as the guards are now in the area, and they probably don't want to interfere with those guards too much. So there's a whole kind of area in front of the lowest gate that is not inhabited by these people. But sure enough, as you approach the gate, you can see Pi and Aeleas walking down, escorted by 2 guards through the lowest gate, and they arrive to meet you.
Hey, look who it is.
Do they look okay? Do they look haggard? Like, we haven't seen them in Maple! A while.
Maple!
You know, anything maybe
so
out
no.
Of
maybe a little bit tired, but actually, more or less, these guys are looking pretty refreshed. Last time you'd all seen each other, you were still kind of, like, beaten up and bruised and all the rest of that from the tower business. No longer. Cleaned up, looking good.
Am I still missing a part of my shoulder?
No. No, you're not.
Yes!
Your complete whole shoulder, in fact. You know,
enjoyable at last. Whole shoulder. You're going to appreciate your shoulder more now, right?
Yeah.
Just stay away from Maple.
I hurt things. It happens.
I hurt the things I love.
What a surprise twist. Maple was the one who threw the dogs down the pit.
Here it
How?
Is.
No one knows.
Stealth check. 2020.
She rolls a critical failure on attack. She's like, wow, nothing bad happened to me. And the dogs just somehow find a way to open up a latch.
That would be my luck.
Well, obviously, I mean, we've got some catching up to do, but everything went okay? And...
Well, yeah, we lived.
Yeah.
Okay, good, good. Well, I've got Helen's ring. Is she here? When is she coming?
Well...
Want to tell him, Pi?
Yeah.
She didn't make
I
it?
I assume by that, she didn't make it then.
She made it, but they took her life anyway.
Hmm.
Something about laws. I was really tired.
I kind of expected that, but I was hoping that, yeah.
Oh. I'm not heartbroken. I did what I did. I mean, I did what I could, I mean. So, yeah. I mean, she did kill my dog and your dog.
I'll put the ring back in my pocket. Yeah.
Well, I also appear to be cured of the power I had. So that's gone. I'm going to try and cast that light spell again.
Sure. Yeah, you don't feel the flows course through you like you did previously. Just
See?
Nothing occurs.
You know, I said that.
I brace myself.
I don't know what to think about that.
Cause... Last time that happened, I got knocked back 10 feet.
Yeah, but it might have hurt us, but it hurt them more. So personally, I mean, I thought it was actually quite a neat.
It's kind of handy.
I wish I could do that. And I'll just...
Need to work on that a little bit. Practice. Yeah.
It went well. Went better than I thought, at least. Saw some pretty messed up shit. You guys were actually there, and you were there, and you were there.
we weren't there.
Well,
it's funny because
it felt like you guys
I'm
were.
I'm quite sure I was sitting on the dock fishing when that was. Yeah. But if you say I was there, then sure.
I mean, Aeleas was terrified. He grabbed my hand. He was like, hold my hand.
That's exactly how it happened.
Anyway.
I didn't know what to do.
Do you guys, I'm sure you guys need some revisions before we leave. I know I've got a few things I'm going to have to collect. They, I need some warmer clothes.
Yeah, they allowed us to stay at least a day. So we'll have time to do what we need, pick up what we need, and then we got to be out by morning.
Okay, well, this might be a good time to consider where we're going then.
Right, well, let's walk and talk, shall we?
Yeah.
Maybe we can find someone who can give us, maybe not to say a map, but maybe a better idea where to head to the next larger city that isn't...
I like that.
...that isn't trying to kill us. Hey,
that would be the best plan.
Where do you guys think we should go for a map? Just wander around the city and look? Should we just go to an inn, ask some information or something?
They have people that read here. There must be somewhere where you can buy scrolls or books or something, I'm sure.
Can you not read?
What?
Can you not read?
I can read, actually.
Huh. Yes, we can read, but it's still not that common. That's
I am a little bit educated.
It might be from the north, but yeah, my town, we were actually, you know... Some brighter than others.
Fair enough. I wasn't trying to be offensive. I can't read.
Look, that's why I kept that book. I don't know what it says. It's not in my language, but...
Yeah, I don't know. I haven't even looked at that book. Anyway, let's head to an inn. Where were you guys, anyway?
We just head back to our inn, and maybe they would...
Oh, yeah, sure.
It's not that far. I personally am looking. I'm going to be looking for a, not necessarily just a merchant, maybe like a blacksmith. But I'm looking for more like a permanent or like a good.
Well, I need to sell my crossbow unless someone wants it. It only has five.
I would be willing to trade you for something, maybe, or I could buy it off you. I mean,
you
know.
You could buy.
I wouldn't mind.
You could buy me a bow, and you can have this.
Okay. Unless, would I want a crossbow or a bow?
Buys a bow? I kind of like this.
No, I think a crossbow would be definitely ideal for me.
Well, then you can have the crossbow and bolts.
Oh. Well, thank you. You said five bolts?
Yes. And it's a light crossbow.
D8. Oh, okay. Yeah. Let's see. Perfect. What do you guys think? I'm thinking maybe in this city we should be able to find a merchant that wants to buy this ornate Kryn sword, as I look to Aeleas. Unless you would like this sword, Aeleas, but if you're with us, probably don't want people to see you with it.
Also, we do still have a little bit of, we have one long sword, two chainmail, and boots from the old mayor from Humbermill.
They're nice.
Just boots?
Yeah, they're gold trimmed, man.
We still have them. They were nice.
Give me your shoes!
Carrying these rotting old leather boots around forever. I found these in a ditch. I'm sure someone will pay us for something for it.
We gotta fill up the cart, guys.
Yeah, looking back now, that does sound pretty fucked.
That's why I'm surprised Aeleas didn't take them when he took everything else. I figured the boots would have been gone.
Yeah. Yeah, you didn't really get to know Antimaeus very well, did you?
Stole their car.
Well, speaking of that, Aeleas, I would say we have an opening, but are you planning on traveling with us? Continue to travel with us, or do you have other pressing matters you have to attend to?
Well, I don't really have anywhere to go after this. If you guys will have me, I would be happy to keep, you know, let's venture on.
Would you have
some questions for me?
Yeah. Why are you with the Kryn? And why is the Kryn trying to kill us?
Yeah, what the hell, man? We shared a high five. Two high fives. One in slow motion.
Yeah. Freeze frame. So just chime in if I start to go in the wrong direction here. Yeah, so as I'm assuming we're like walking somewhere as we're chatting, maybe. Anyways. Yeah, so my parents were actually a part of the Kren, so I was just kind of born into it. And as I was growing up, both of them died. And I was kind of just taken in by one of their good friends who was kind of a higher up in the organization there as kind of an uncle or godfather, as you will. And that's how I got into a part of the Kren. I'm sure you guys heard me back there in the tower. Things have been changing, so I don't know a whole lot about what we were doing or why.
So it wasn't really your choice.
No, I was kind of born into it, and I agreed with a lot of what we did. We did a lot of demon slaying and stuff like that, so I didn't see anything wrong with what we stood for. But in the last short while, and the party that you guys actually encountered may have been with them, and I may have fled.
You were the one we saw running away.
Oh, shit.
Da, da, da.
I know you.
It's a good thing we didn't recognize you. We probably would have stabbed you right when we found you by the roadside there.
I was half expecting that.
I think Antimaeus hunted you down, too. Didn't catch up, though.
So we need Antimaeus back, but... as long as he has a bunch of gold still and whatnot.
Jordan will laugh when he hears this because his comment to me was Alex's appearance was just way too convenient. Like, why was he right there right then? And I was like, maybe you'll find out one day, maybe you won't.
Like, ah, damn it. How about by now we're at the tavern, we're just going to sit down for a treat because we've got to...
Sure. Yeah, you guys arrive. 100%. You guys arrive at the inn. The innkeeper here has gotten to know you guys over the last 10 days. I mean, most people don't stay that long in an inn unless they're, you know, really, really kind of making a home here. So he walks up and greets you and says,
"Ah, my favorite customers. Can I get you both your usuals? And how about your friends here?"
That's a usuals all around.
Yeah.
What is, I don't quite know what their usuals be. What can I get for you, sirs?
I would like a tall glass of cold milk. And that's it.
Consider it done. Yes. How about you?
I'll take two ales, please.
Two ales. All right, so four ales and a cold milk. Done.
What's this inn called?
This inn is called the Cloak and Beggar.
Yes!
Very nice.
I live for inn names. I have to hear
them.
And for an inn that has the name Beggar in it, it's not too bad of an establishment. Like, it's certainly not the highest quality by any means. You've probably been in nicer places, but it's nice and homey. The people here are generally fairly kind. Other adventurers that are clearly coming through the city seem to enjoy the place as well. They typically have live music. So, you know, it's not a bad place. You haven't had problems here as of yet.
I'm sure Maple's had her drums out here a few times in the last week. Or 10 days.
Yeah, exactly. And if so, people are just absolutely happy that you're joining in. And they're happy to talk if you want to. It's a fairly friendly place.
Okay. Okay, so going back to Aeleas here, I'm just curious, like, are the Kren looking for you? Do they assume you're dead? Or if we run into the Kren again, are they going to be like, hey, what are you doing with... Just...
I'm going to assume they think I'm dead with the rest of the party that you guys encountered there. Mm-hmm. I don't actually know what's going to happen if I go back. I don't have my ring anymore because I think I left that at the tower. Mm-hmm. Is that correct? I never asked for it back. So I'm assuming they kept it.
Yes, they would have hung on to it. Yep.
Okay. Yeah. So I don't have a ring anymore to get into any camps or anything like that. So unless I run into somebody I know.
What if you have like a Kren captain's sword? Or
that might raise some questions.
Has Aeleas seen that sword, or have? I don't think I was.
You guys have pulled it out a couple times.
Oh, okay.
Oh, can you tell me anything about this sword? I mean, it looks nice. I certainly don't want to use it myself, just because of what it represents, I guess. But again, from what you've said, told me about the Kren, it's not all bad. It's just all I know of the Kren in my dealings is bad. But.
And that's fair. You guys have not had the greatest experience with them. Do I know any truths that I can share? I would be so truthful.
The captain that had led your troop was a particularly fervent one. You've served under other captains previously, but this guy was just like top-notch crazy, for lack of a better term. He was really the one that believed in not only the Kren's values, but taking the Kren's values to a whole new level. So this sword was just kind of part of that persona.
So other ones didn't really...
No, okay. He had it custom crafted. Like, he spent a year's worth of his wages there on doing this. He's just, yeah, he was just hardcore. And his hate for Kaidame was above any other Kren that you've really ever met. He was a very big believer in this new age group of Kren ideas.
Oh, I'm glad I gutted him.
The sword, to your knowledge, doesn't have any significant implications aside from the fact it's custom made for him,
and very probably very recognizable within the Kren.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So for that, yeah. So my question is, we could try to sell this. I'm sure someone in the city here would want like a memento of a Kren, you know, a sword like this. Or, I mean, would you want to use it or that?
I'm happy to stay as far away from that as I need to.
We could.
Sure, no, I just don't really.
I'm glad to hear what happened to him, though. Good
we
job,
could
guys.
See if we can get it appraised and get an actual value for it, or
yeah.
See if it's better to sell it as a whole, as an ornate Kren sword from a fallen general, or melt it down and sell it as for pieces.
Trade it for some silver, maybe.
Yeah.
That's why I want to go see a blacksmith as soon as possible.
Did you, Aeleas, know anything about that? Do you remember that creepy monster face guy that we when we're saving all the prisoners in the tower ruins?
That was all very new to me.
Yeah. That wasn't Kren, though, was it? Or was that something entirely different?
No, that was. An entirely different. We don't do any weird practices or rituals or anything like that. We're very anti otherworldly power / influence, I guess, if you will. That was all new. I haven't seen anything like that or their tabards or anything like that in my time with the Kren.
Yeah, I wonder what the hell that was all about.
Cleared that up.
So before we go shopping and sell stuff and all of this, does anyone want a longsword or chainmail?
No, I'm good.
Good.
Right, because I've got some chainmail already. Unless that's better looking stuff.
I don't think so. I think this is probably the same stuff you got.
Yeah. This
so
point,
Aeleas,
the innkeeper returns, places the drinks. Gives you kind of a nod and wanders off.
I'm gonna slam my first one back, like just boom, and then I'm gonna sip on the second one.
I'm gonna smell my milk and make sure it's not sour.
Right. He sees you slam back the first one. He's like, ha ha ha!
I'll just give him like a nod with the empty glass as I put it down.
I'll raise my beer up for a little bit of like a cheers. You know. We're still alive for now.
Yay.
Just out of curiosity, because we've obviously learned a lot about you, Aeleas, is there anything else we need to know or should know or that you want to fill us in on?
That was my secret, really.
There's definitely worse secrets than that, I guess.
Everything else, I think, is normal.
I'll say it, because now that I think about it, if you wanted us dead back then, we all would have probably, you could have killed us in our sleep pretty easily.
So just out of curiosity, is there any side effects to your guys' ritual or whatever happened in there? Or are you guys, good to go now?
Not that I know of. I mean...
They said we've been stripped of our powers and relations. Were you about to elaborate on that? Okay. I should let you guys know, I talked to Helen about it a little bit. When she revived me, there was this voice inside me. I'm not too sure what it was, but I heard it again.
Ghostface.
So, no. It was after the ghostface. Maybe. I don't know.
You're a ghost. That's proof.
That I don't know anything about either. But you have it too, so.
Are you scared of ghosts?
So I heard this voice, and during our trial, I heard it again after I thought we woke up. But apparently we didn't. So that's maybe a thing. But they also said we've been stripped of everything. So, I think they're a lot wiser than I am. We'll see.
I don't know, man, but I feel refreshed.
So, okay, well, that's good, I guess. But I don't understand. If you guys have been stripped of everything, shouldn't you be bonded? I thought that was the point of the ritual. I guess it failed because they killed Helen, but. Shouldn't you guys be dead?
No, because she broke one of their laws, right?
Yeah.
Bringing him back.
Yeah, that's what they've been saying.
So that was
we assumed she was going to die just for that alone.
Yeah, that was her punishment. At least that's what I gathered from it. I'm still tired.
I think what they were trying to do was bond us all with our powers, but because we had somehow been stripped of them, that was technically a failure, which is why they killed Helen.
But you heard it too.
But we walked away better than this.
You heard it too, though, right?
That it was a success?
Yeah, right before I went under, I heard that.
Clear as day.
But he kept denying it.
Yeah. So that's why I don't know what happened.
Maybe they just couldn't get over the fact that she had broken the law as bad as she did, and...
Was that
even if it had
Scarface that kept denying it?
Yeah,
that's okay. Yeah, Scarface.
I know who Scarface is.
Oh yeah, he's been talking to him.
Oh, okay.
He was like the main guy that sat in like the front chair.
Oh, okay, okay.
That, that big scarf. Yeah.
Plate mail.
The part that confuses me. The part that confuses me the most is that they said if we didn't get Pythagoras's powers under control, it could be dangerous for everybody involved, anybody around him at any given point. So I don't know why they'd lie to us about that, but we also both heard that it was a success. So I don't know.
Do you think maybe Scarface there is maybe working another side?
Interesting.
Oh, and when you lose your powers, where do they go? They just up and disappear? Does somebody take them, or do they just...
Now the discussion has been had, you guys thought maybe you were just a little bit hungry, thirsty before, but you've had some drinks, they've probably brought some food, you've had a little bit of that. You're starting to realize there's something that you're feeling unfulfilled about, and it's more than just base needs. You're feeling like something is kind of missing from you, almost like
all of us, or just the two of us?
Sorry, just the two of you.
Okay.
There's something just kind of missing from you, a void or a gap.
While we're talking and eating, can I do an insight check on both of them? I just want to see if they seem off at all, like if there's something peculiar just that they may be doing now or not that they would have before.
Sure. Yeah, Pythagoras seems a little less douchey.
No, fuck you, Amagar. Sick of your shit.
There he is. I was wondering when he would come in.
Takes a little getting used to.
Just like good old normal Pythagoras. Yeah. Aeleas. Although Aeleas maybe looks like he got a tan or something. You're not sure.
He looks prettier than usual.
A little glow from when they killed Helen off.
So we're feeling unfulfilled. Am I still like feeling hungry though? Or am I just like, I take a few bites and I'm like, I don't want this.
Yeah, you're just kind of,
it
upset's not the word for it, but exactly what you're just described. Like, eat a few bites of food. No, I'm not feeling this. Just I need something. I'm just not sure what it is. You feel kind of empty.
So it's not so much in a way of like hunger. We think it's hunger, but then it's like, oh, you know, I'm not really hungry. Or just more of like a mental, emotional emptiness.
Yeah, kind of. A little bit of all of the above. It's just a really strange feeling that you've never felt before.
Yeah, I don't know. I just don't want this milk. It tastes like failure. Just push it aside.
Pythagoras, considering you guys are alive, I would consider that a great victory, because we very nearly did not walk away from
that. No, I get that. It's just that, I don't know, something, I just, I don't know, feel numb.
Right? No.
Feel numb. I don't know, maybe I just need more sleep. So I'm gonna go, maybe take like an hour nap or something upstairs in one of our rooms. Sure. We do have rooms here, right? I'm not just gonna go into a room and be like, oh.
you do have two rooms. Obviously, Almagar and Maple were in each one, but each of those rooms have two beds in them.
Okay,
so you're definitely able to stay in one as well.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, I guess I'll just throw him the key if he wants to run up for a rest and. In that case, is there anything you need?
Yeah, we can go do
vision-wise, we can go grab you a few stuff. We'll be out and about anyway. Just unless we're just buying rations and stuff. That's basic food stuff. Sure.
Well, the map, like you said, was definitely that's the most priority for sure. If you can pick up some more healer kits. Actually, you know what? I'll get that later. It's gonna be a quick nap. I'll be down and out, and then I'll be up. And...
Well, do you want us to maybe just wait for you then?
No, I'll meet you guys back here. It's fine.
So if you're just going for a short, I don't mind staying here and drinking some more beer.
Yeah, sure. Oh, it's up to you guys. Whatever.
Yeah, we'll wait for you, and we'll do it all at once. Yeah. It's not a big deal.
So I'll attempt to catch the keys and perfectly catch them.
Then I'll head fail up. And get a key stuck in
there.
Go back to the towers.
Why do these things happen?
Help!
This day gets worse and worse. This is throwing the keys.
This is still a trial. I'm gonna slam the rest of my other beer and gesture for another one.
Say another round or another round.
A young man comes back and takes a look at each of your mugs and just picks each one up and goes, "Yeah, all right, I'll be right back." He walks away with the empty mugs.
Quality.
Confused by what I just witnessed, but not gonna say anything. I'm gonna kind of shake that one off.
He comes back shortly later, or shortly after, with four more mugs of ale. He puts two in front of you again.
Oh, shit.
So has anyone taken in consideration of what? I mean, Aeleas, you said you're not going to be going back to the Krem. So, any idea on like, are you gonna stay with us for a little bit, or do you, are you gonna?
Yeah. I mean, it doesn't. Do you guys have any idea what you're gonna be doing? I don't really have anywhere to go after this, so. I'm cool to stick around. We can.
Well, sounds like we're all in the same boat. None of us have homes. We're all just.
That could be done around here. I mean, like, there's. Yeah. Like they said, the forest has been naturally aggressive with the creatures in here lately. I'm kind of curious about that. And just before we got here, I saw that. I don't know. That vampire guy. He's out there. Like, he knows we're here. So I'm kind of thinking we should stick around. I think he's part of the reason why we had that horde of spiders attack us. And just, like, those incidences.
Where did you guys see him again? The first time?
The first time I saw him in... Crowmill. It was at one of the farms. Well, just outside one of the farms when I was on my way back to the actual city.
Then we ran into more on the way to the city, and then on the way to the... with the cart, that's right, before we abandoned the cart.
Mm-hmm.
Who was telling us before that we should... Yeah, like, the forest would have, you know, lots of things to kill.
Well, one of the guys in the tower mentioned that.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sure we could find someone who would be willing to pay for us to go, you know, do some exterminating.
Well, I was thinking...
What would you think of heading west of the city?
Well, we could always backtrack back to...
Briac.
Briac.
And see if any of the villagers there are... Like, because they go out into the woods a lot. They might know specific areas where we can just go and, you know, like, oh, there's more wolf activity over here or something than normal.
Yeah, now that they're back, who knows what they might need a hand with. I know they were scared of that road we took with the cart.
Yeah, and they don't really have any defenses there, yeah.
That, and quite a few of them have died. I'm sure there's... I wouldn't necessarily say business opportunities, but I'm sure there's...
Find something to do.
We might need some supplies and all that. I don't think we need to go all the way back to a big city in order to be able to help people right now.
True, I mean, bigger cities are where there's more work.
It may not be as glorious as, you know, Pythagoras would like, but, I mean, it's getting on to winter. It couldn't hurt to find a few jobs to kind of... get some gold in our pockets before the snow hits.
Yeah, and we gotta start somewhere, because, yeah, we can't just, again...
Is there anything of interest that I could mention to the west? Yeah. So I'll... I know the main Kren base is to the west.
To the east. There's the east.
Oh, fuck. Yeah. I was gonna say, my brain went backwards.
Right, I got backwards too. I don't want to head back west.
It's my fault for the fact that I've probably shown you guys the map this way several times, and it's like in reverse to you guys. So I think that's what it was.
Probably. Yeah.
So I meant to the east. the main like Kren base, I guess we'll call it, is far east. But I don't know.
Is there anything I could mention
on the way?
So the Kren, like, fortress, the main kind of station of them, which has developed really into a small city as very, like, xenophobic and loyal to the Kren people sort of flock there. It's kind of become a fortress surrounded by a town, almost.
Okay.
It's your Trump joke.
Yeah. But regardless, it is a big journey.
Oh, so it's like
really far out to the east.
So there's a lot in the way.
There's like a point where you take a boat and then you land on another piece of land. And it would be a huge journey. And on the very valid point you guys made about winter, you're in the northern part of this area. It's gonna get cold.
Winter is coming.
Winter is coming.
oh,
hopefully this one's not full of, you know, zombies or whatever. But yeah, it's gonna get cold dead. And
we've already been there.
And while you're not gonna die from being outside, it's not that harsh. It's certainly not weather that you want to be traveling in if you don't need to.
All men must die.
All. Maybe even women. But... see.
Okay, enough Game of Thrones.
And I assume we don't want to go back to Arendelle, because I got a bad vibe from that city.
Mm-hmm. Or at least not until we've done some better deeds.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I didn't really answer your question either, though. On your way there, there are definitely lots of things. So,
is there something in, like, a reasonable travel amount of time?
The nearest would be Fellhorn, which is another large city.
And according to the map, it does not have much for trees around.
No. It is kind of the rival city to Arendelle. Oh, so okay. It's about the same size, it's fairly large, and it's the one that they mentioned they had some tension with when you guys were there, and have in the past had wars.
And the way we retreated in Arendelle, we might be welcomed in...
sorry, what was your question?
Do they have another tower there, or it's just the cities that are kind of rivaling?
Okay.
And how far of a travel?
That would take you into winter to get there. So, okay. Like, when you arrive there, that would have to be your final destination until spring, unless you really want to push you guys south through the winter. Yeah.
Now, do you think, because Arendelle is located right near the forests, do you, like, as much as we hate the West, well, so far our experience at least, maybe I'm sure we can find some work in Arendelle and do that. Maybe do that for the winter.
So obviously the villages you guys came from were further to the west near the coast. There is a larger city near the coast as well. It's a little bit southwest. It would still be a long journey, probably the same distance to Fellhorn, but you'd be on the coast if that makes any difference to you guys.
Personally, I would prefer to go to the coast, but that's, again, I'm from the coast, so that's I'm a little biased that way. What do you guys think?
I like the coast option. That's forest and coast and mountain areas are.
Sounds like a good place to spend the winter.
Yeah, it's been a while since I've been down that way. I'd be game.
Like I said, I know when we do, I need to certainly get some better winter gear. Because it might not be full on winter yet, but we're still getting some pretty cool nights. So.
Yeah, certainly.
Need more furs.
Yeah. Okay. So you guys have been sitting down here talking about this for a bit. If you wish, your nap can be done.
Did I have any weird dreams, or did I have trouble sleeping at all, or?
You definitely had some issues getting to sleep, and what's starting to eat away at you now is the fact that this magic just isn't... you're pretty sure that this might be related to that kind of void.
Am I, like, missing it?
Something missing. Yeah, it's like, when you use the power, it's not that it feels good, but it definitely... power courses through your veins. Like, it's given that name for a reason, right? And... the fact that you just can't experience that right now, it's almost like withdrawal.
Yeah. Well, yeah, the potential you had, like, Almagar, like, I was jealous of your powers. I want to be able to do that.
Yeah, I felt heroic, so I could see why I'm feeling that way now. I'd probably be looking at my broken rapier, how it's unfinished, and just thinking to myself, I'm unfinished.
100%.
But yeah, I'll wake up and I'll come downstairs now.
So Pythagoras joins the rest of you at the table. And hey, there's already an ale just sitting there.
Yeah. I'm good. All right, you want to go shopping, guys?
So I'm a little worried about Pythagoras. Yeah, he's not one to normally pass up ale, but...
It's nothing.
Gone through a lot. I mean, it's.
I just missed the barbarian brew I made. That was quality stuff. So.
Hey,
nothing,
you know,
tastes
what?
Quite the same.
Got you drunk.
We've done it once. We could do it again.
We could.
And if, yeah, what wall? Wherever we do spend the winter, we'll have plenty of time to get our own.
Well, I was gonna say that could be something to look into for provisions, is buying yourselves a few kegs and caskets or whatever supplies you need, and
winter. And we could use some real, like,
some good stuff.
It's not too late. You could probably still find some apples and whatnot. You could probably make some pretty good.
Did you guys discuss anything about, like, after, like, in the morning, where we're going?
Oh, yes. We were discussing heading southwest. There's a city on the coast, and I'm thinking that might be a good... Or we're thinking that might be a good place to spend the winter.
Did I ever tell you about the time I stole a sword from a pirate? I don't like water.
Briefly, I guess you have mentioned that. Tell us about that some more, because, why not?
Well,
another round!
Aeleas begins cracking up.
Pirate?
I call for another round.
Arr, he shivered his timbers.
All right, well.
I'll, like, lean back, like, this should be a good one.
When I was a boy, about 4 years ago, 5 years ago, I was homeless, basically. I lived with my mother. She took care of me, but I never knew my dad. He was apparently a thief and a scoundrel. He just disappeared, never met him.
So the apple didn't fall too far from the tree.
Yeah. And yeah, so I took to thieving myself just to support my mother and me. When she got sick, I started working for a woman called Rowan Kellifin. She was a part of the pirates called the Red Lotus. It's actually a pretty famous pirate band. I don't know if you've ever heard of them. But she is very renowned. And she has this terrifying creature. Anyway, I worked with her. And one day I decided to steal her prized sword from her cabin. I picked the lock, snuck in, took the sword, and I'd show you guys the rapier. It's got a red blade, and it's very ornamental.
Is this the broken one?
Yeah. And I went to go sell it to a merchant, show my mother, but by the time I got back, my mother was passed away from the illness. So there was no choice or no point in selling the sword to get the money for the doctor. So I just kept it, and I decided to journey and prove to myself and the world that I'm destined for greater things. And ever since then, Rowan's been hunting me for that sword. I don't know what it means to her. It might be her personal possession, like prized possession, but she's been chasing me, and she's been sending her pet called Gut Tugger. It's this giant lizard thing. I don't know what the hell it is. It is terrifying. About the size of a deer.
When was the last time you saw that?
All the time. I've been on the run for 4 years. That's why I go to city to city to city.
But, like, have you seen it since I met you guys?
No. I don't think, have I? Have I seen anything in the corner of my eye with this stuff?
I mean, you've been on the lookout. Just avoiding. Like, you know, you see some guy walk by in, like, vibrantly colored clothes, and you're just, holy shit! But it turns out not to be, you know, a giant lizard. But you haven't specifically seen it yet, though. Now, sorry, I will say that as you pull out the rapier to show everyone, it is fixed.
Oh. Was it fixed when I took it out in the bedroom when I woke up?
No.
Give me a minute.
That is a very nice rapier.
Back the wagon up.
What's up?
We don't have a wagon.
Yeah, but
shut up, Almagar.
Why are you gonna bring that back up?
My losses. I used to like it when you could cast magic. Wasn't it great when we had a cart?
God damn it.
The greatest here in all the lands is pretty fucking useless now.
I can't do anything about it.
She could tell your mom.
Oh, he went there.
Your mom would be so proud.
Hey, you guys. Anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, this was broken just a few moments ago before I came down here.
Like,
it's not
like,
broken.
Like almost.
During your nap?
I woke up. It was still broken.
I'm not magic, yet. I'm still not magic.
I'm going to try and do light.
Just take hand again.
Yeah.
Okay, so you try and do like a mend or the light.
Light.
Put out your hand. Nothing happens. You're looking for that kind of source deep within you that allows you to normally do this. You just keep hitting emptiness and emptiness. And for a moment, almost like somebody just kind of pokes you in the side, it comes back, and a little spark occurs in your palm. But then it...
I thought you guys didn't have the gift anymore.
That fucking lying piece of shit.
As I'm staring at his hand, I'm waving for another drink.
I'm just gonna keep trying harder and harder.
And it just, at this point, it's just not coming back.
Wait, Pythagoras. Yeah, I saw that, right?
Oh yeah, you all four of you saw that.
Okay.
Is there anything nearby I can break?
Sorry?
Is there anything nearby I can break?
Amagar's face, fucking asshole.
Just kidding. I mean, the table you're sitting at is wooden.
Is there the ale glass? Is that wooden as well?
Yeah, they're wood. Yeah, wood with like little like metal kind of brackets around them.
We'll skip up for now.
another round comes. The serving boy takes away the rest of the empty mugs.
Hey, Pythagoras. Whatever that just was, let's keep that on the download until we're out of here, because...
After he says, I'm going to look around and see if anybody else noticed that.
Do you want to give me a perception check there? In fact, all you can if you so wish.
Ooh. 20.
24.
Perception...
If you don't have perception.
23.
What is that perception? What is perception? You know, for crying out loud.
If you don't have perception, it'll just be wisdom.
Wisdom.
Oh, okay, right. Yeah, I rolled a natural 20, so that's 21. Okay. Of all the things to roll a 20 on.
We're all really into this right now.
You are all very confident. No one noticed. You were just, like, when you saw it happen, you kind of realized that it was out in the open. You just weren't expecting it to happen, and you very quickly withdrew your hand. And nobody seemed to really notice too much. And there, it's midday, so there's lots of light in here, so it's not like there's a big flash in the darkness or anything else.
Yeah, I agree. And I also think maybe we should leave a little sooner than we need to.
I would agree.
I think we should just get our stuff and go.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
Something's not right this place.
I already have all my stuff on me. Like I said, I definitely need to see a blacksmith before we go.
Well, if the blacksmith is something that you didn't necessarily need to wait for, it's definitely something you could have taken care of in that 10-day as well. So if you'd that to have been done, we can definitely say it was, and we can just discuss what happened there. But as you're all sitting up, you hear a pound, pound, pound on the indoor, and everybody just goes quiet for a moment.
I'm gonna finish my drink.
I'll be finishing if I've got anything left.
I'm gonna smell that milk.
You know what? For as far as like in milk goes and close to winter, it's pretty, you know, not sour. I mean, it's on the edge, but it's on the acceptable edge.
I like my warm from the tip still, right? Like just as fresh as it comes. Those cream float on the top.
Dirt. Yeah.
The hair.
The innkeep walks up to the door And as he's walking, goes, "The inn's open. You're welcome to come on in." And he opens the door, and a hand comes to the door and just kind of sort of grabs him on the shoulder, but pushes him back gently. As four guards walk into the room, they're not city guards, though. They have the shield with this, the lightning bolt on.
So, like, the ones that escorted us out of the tower kind of deal?
Specters.
And then, following those four, comes a man in full plate armor. No one you've seen, so you don't recognize him, but also with a tabard of the shield and lightning bolt on him. And in behind him, after he's kind of looked left and right and inspected the room, comes a girl in these kind of fine white robes. They walk in, and as they're walking in, the innkeeper says, "Is this something I can help you with? Can I get you some drinks, some food? We're honored to host a Kai Dame." And she doesn't say a word. And he looks at the innkeeper and just says, "I'd like to have a look." He says, "Yes, certainly, but I'm sure whatever you're seeking, you won't find." And the guy half unsheathes his sword just to display the top of his blade. And the innkeeper goes, "Okay, search around as much."
What's this inn look like? What's the setup? What are we looking at?
So, although it has rooms upstairs, it's much more of a common house tavern than it really is a true inn. So the entire most inns will that have a like a common room, they'll kind of have it off to the side, and there'll be some rooms down below and that sort of thing. This, the whole bottom floor is a common room, and then there's like a set of stairs that leads up to like one floor of rooms. So it's very much more of a tavern. But anyways, it's big open area. There's a bar directly across from the main large heavy door at the front of the building, and then other than that, it's just tables throughout. This place probably seats maybe 100 people at capacity, so it's a fairly it's not a tiny place.
So are there a lot of people in it right now?
Yes, yeah, it's pretty full.
Are we close to the front door area?
You're kind of off to the, if you were to walk through the doors, you're kind of off to the right a little bit, and maybe like six tables in, so you're fairly close to the front door. I mean, not right up there, but pretty close.
But probably like pretty noticeable if we're all standing up right now.
Especially because everybody else is sitting and staring. Especially, yes.
Shit. Okay.
Is it like crowded in here?
Fairly, yeah. Yeah, it's almost at capacity, so there's almost like another 100 people in here.
Can I attempt to blend in a little bit?
Yeah, certainly. Yeah, if you want to give me a stealth check, if you have, you can. Otherwise, you can give me dexterity.
If I have stealth. I was an urchin.
Nice. Where did Pythagoras go? No.
What have you done?
It's like, oh, then, what did you do to the table?
I rolled a 10.
Can all four of you please also give me a charisma check? If you have deception, please give me deception instead.
Oh. Way to go, Almagar!
5.
I rolled a 2, and with my charisma bonus, that's a total of 2. Do I get a roll of advantage?
What'd you get?
12.
And, sorry, what did you get, Pi?
7. I got -1 to my charisma. I'm terrible.
Hey guys, over here! I thought you're looking for us.
So as they walk in, they walk through a few of the tables, look around, and her eyes fixate on you guys almost immediately. They start to slowly walk over to you and make their way to the table. The four guards stay up.
Everybody look up.
The four guards stay at the front door, but the Kaidame and the Kaidan approach you. Pi, you're pretty confident that while maybe you're not exuding the most convincing air, that if you wanted to, just by the angle you're kind of sitting, you strategically moved yourself when they immediately walked in, if you like ducked under the table or something right now, they probably would not notice that you did it.
Yeah, I'll do that.
So you jut down really quick. Three of you notice. Table.
Do they look familiar? Like we haven't seen this Kaidan Kaidan before.
These two are completely new.
Okay.
Do they have kind of an aggressive look to them? Like,
I wouldn't say aggressive, but stone faced. Like, there's just no emotion. However, they're definitely feeling threatening, especially the guy in the armor. The quickness to which he drew his sword before makes you think he could probably have that thing out, taking someone's head in just as quick of a time. But they don't. They definitely don't look angry. They don't look aggressive. They're just blank faced.
And everybody's like staring silently at them now.
It's just the whole inn has gone silent. Music has stopped. People are not drinking. The clanking in the back has stopped. All of the barmaids and barmen are just standing, waiting to see what happens.
Would you say I'm drunk by now?
Someone's been sure in a hurry.
Give me a percentile dice roll. So that's
fair.
2d10s, and we're going to compare it. I also need to know your constitution, and I'll give you an answer.
Okay.
Wow, you're still conscious? No. What is this, Dwarven Ale?
These ones, right?
Yep. Wait, and that'll be the tens place, and that's the sixes place. Yeah.
Or
the
fifth place. that's a 10. And I've got 12 for constitution.
Alright. Yeah, you're drunk. You're really, really intoxicated. Yeah.
So would you say I'm probably not picking up on the heat of the situation?
I'll leave that one up to you, but I would more so side to you're a little less cautious than normally. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
How are Elvagar and I looking?
Well, I've only had like 2, so.
Yeah, you guys will be fine. He's taken down, I think, 4 or 5.
4
now,
yeah.
So, yeah.
Very good.
You guys are all right. 2 is not.
I assume he's a little more scrawny than me, too. I don't know.
Yeah, he's a pretty thin guy, so. All right, so they approach your table. They don't say anything for a few moments. And they don't, while they approached you, they don't focus on you the entire time. They still look at other tables while they're passing by. Meet the eyes of a few individuals, but when they fully arrive and stop, she says, "May I ask your names?"
I am Almagar, son of Luthor.
Make something up.
Maple Helmborn. Maybe ask who you are.
You may not. She looks to Aeleas.
Oh, that's a pretty good line. I gotta remember that. As I think that to myself under this table there.
So now knowing how drunk I am, I'm looking up with one eye.
He gets a lazy eye when he's drunk.
I think you guys know who I am.
I think so.
I can assure you it's not. Your name, please.
Well, I think you'll be able to ask your friends upstairs at the tower. Because they sent us down here.
This is Aeleas.
I just found out how drunk I am, okay, guys?
He looks to her. They visited the tower earlier. These must have been the ones released earlier today. She says, interesting. Were there not 4 of you?
What do you want?
You
killed one of us.
Were there not four of you total after the tower?
Helen's still up there. She looks at you, Maple, and you, Almagar, and just starts ignoring Aeleas.
I apologize. We've had a long day.
I understand. The quicker you answer my question, I'm sure the quicker I can leave you be. Are there four of you or no?
Yes, there are four of us.
Where is the fourth?
I know he was resting, but he was supposed to join us again here soon.
She looks to him, and he just gives her a quick nod. She looks to
My question. What do you want? You won't tell us your names. You want all this info from us? We've already been released from the tower. What's going on?
She looks at you. She doesn't say a word. And then she turns and walks away. The man in the armor goes back and talks to the guards. She accompanies him. And after saying a few words, the guards run upstairs. And you can hear them pounding around for probably 5 to 10 minutes.
Oh shit, oh shit.
Should probably come out now, I don't think. Yeah.
They come down, and you see a couple of them shake their head. The Kaidame and Kaidan approach you again and say, while I highly doubt we were incorrect, I hope that you'll advise your comrade that if he finds the power still within him, to return the tower for his own good. Thank you. And she turns around again, and the two of them walk out of the door, followed by the four guards. And it's quiet for like a moment again, and you just hear like a couple...
I'm actually going to get up and I'm going to go to the door just to see what direction to see they're actually leaving.
Oh shit, she's maple marked.
And I'm going to give Almagar one of these.
And I'll give another cheers with my glass.
They head back towards the tower. They head that direction.
I'll come back and I'll just proclaim to the whole tavern, they're gone. And then I'll sit back down at the table.
Alright, it's silent for a few moments, and then the guy who's plucking his lute starts playing and reading his poetry again, and then people start talking, and the volume slowly raises again.
And I'll come out of the table.
The innkeep walks over to you and says, friends, I don't know if I really want to know what that was about, and I won't ask, it's none of my business, but if I were you and I gave some friendly advice, the Kaidame don't normally pay for people just to hang around in an inn. I would leave with haste.
Yes, we're sorry for bringing that upon you. I have no idea why they would, but we thought we were done with.
Honestly, they probably would have come regardless. I don't know what you could have done sitting here drinking ale to have triggered them. Who knows? It's not uncommon for them to occasionally pop in, though not with such disdain. Regardless, it's none of my business. Have another round on the house, or rather, I won't lie, on the Kaidame's money. And if you're ever back in Aelioth, under better circumstances, be sure to drop back into the Cloak and Beggar. It's been a pleasure having you.
Question.
We have enjoyed our stay, yeah.
What's your name,
yes, sir? Ah, my name. Jeffrey.
Well, Jeffrey.
It's quite a strange name.
Yeah, that's good.
He starts to try to break into a story, you just like interrupt him.
Hypothetically speaking, I mean, say, like, they hunt people with the power, don't they? These Kaidame?
I don't right know, so exactly what they do, but yes, something like that.
What if there was, like, hypothetically somebody in here they were looking for? Like, what would they do? Would they harm them, or...
I don't rightly know, sir. I've never encountered such a situation, but...
Okay, I was just curious.
Hypothetically, I would say that person might want to distance themselves from the guy named...
Can I tell that he knows I'm talking about myself? Like, does he get the gist of it?
Yeah, he seems like, I mean, he's an innkeep, he's not the smartest guy in the world, but he's not a total idiot either, so, you know, maybe okay.
I'm going to do, like, the cover my face from him and be like, I think he's talking about you.
I'm going to take his ale.
Could you actually help direct us? We're looking for a map. We need a better map of the area for our travels. Do you know if somewhere we go for that?
Oh, well, I'm a simple man myself. I don't rightly seek maps very often, but I believe there's a car... Oh, what do they call themselves? Cartographers?
Cartographers?
I don't know. Yes, something map like maker? That. A map maker. He has some long, fancy word for himself. But yes, he gives you some directions further into the city. It's not too far from here. He says he actually likes to pop into the Cloak and Beggar once in a while. So, you know, say I sent you, and maybe he'll have a special deal for you.
Oh, most definitely.
I think we should go, guys.
Yeah. All right. Aeleas, are you feeling up for a little stroll? Or do we have to carry you?
I'm fine. Thank you, Jeremy.
High five!
Yes, thank you, Jeffrey, for all your help and your hospitality.
I'm just gonna, like, kind of lean against the table as I'm standing.
So you have your last few drinks, you gather your things. And...
I'm going to grab whatever, if there's like a scrap of like some whatever food's left on the table, I'm going to grab a little bit and just hand it to Aeleas. Like, here, have some more bread.
I love bread.
It's okay, that cheese, it's some good cheese on there. I've had worse.
I'll snack on it.
I guess this is okay. Good to go. As you exit the inn, the brisk air and the food in your stomach starts to help sober you up a little bit.
Brisk.
Some snowflakes are starting to kind of drift down. It's not snowing, but you know, it's kind of got that beginning of winter breeze. It's kind of maybe raining a little bit, but it's now coming down in frozen flakes.
So, Pythagoras, how badly did you not want to go to the coast? Because... less likely to find this white stuff there.
Also, something maybe to mention, I don't know what you're thinking, but we do have a sled without a dog. I do need to get another mount at some point.
Right.
Or multiple ones.
Yeah.
If we're Can't you just, like, go in the forest and tame an animal or something? Isn't that what you did?
No. We had dogs in our village. Oh. I just...
Once again, I'm being very racist. I'm sorry. I thought you were all illiterate barbarians. I didn't know. I'm sorry.
Not the most civilized compared to some.
I prefer the term northern folk.
Fair enough.
Civilization deprived? No, no, that's not good.
So you've. Sorry, go
ahead. So, Pythagoras, I know we were talking about this pirate lady who wanted her rapier back. Obviously just giving it back to her, but I don't think that's really an option right now, but can you think of a way to maybe, if we were to confront this, or is there anything we can do to help you get these things, like, from, like, not following you anymore, or?
Unless you can...
Do you think we could kill this monster of hers?
No, she's a very skilled swordswoman. She's very, very powerful. And she has a very, very huge armada. She has an armada of pirates.
Long ships?
What's that?
She have any long ships?
Probably. I haven't seen her full fleet, but I mean... Her ship... There's pirates all over the seas. Her ship alone is huge. I believe it's called a galley. I don't know, but it's monstrous. It's called the Sea Wyvern.
Okay, maybe the coast we might want to reconsider here.
That's not even what's scary. If you saw her pet, Gut Tugger is horrifying. I don't know what that fucking thing is, but it's relentless. Once it gets your scent, it'll never leave you alone. That's why I'm always running.
How big is this thing?
It's about the size of a deer, like maybe bigger.
Oh, dear Lord.
So, would you... Okay, so, Pythagoras, are your plans to keep this rapier? This is your weapon, or until you know more about it, or do you want to sell it, or...
No, this is my weapon. It's pretty much the only thing I have left of my mother, to remind me of my mother, basically. And it's to remind me that I'm going to be something better than an urchin. So, it's very sentimental to me. I'm not giving it up. And she can go fuck herself. She wouldn't give me the money to pay for the doctor, so I stole that rapier from her to sell it to get the money. But now my mother's dead.
Some things are more important.
Yep.
Yeah.
I mean,
and so if other than looking nice, the sword doesn't do anything special. It's not like
apparently it fixes itself. I don't know.
Yeah.
She wants it badly for some reason. That's why I'm keeping it.
Yeah, to go through that much trouble. I guess maybe it's sentimental to her. Maybe her mother gave it to her, and that was all she had left.
She's been hunting me for 4 years for it, so...
Okay, so again, at least we should know that, you know, we might have some surprise, you know.
Yeah. But I mean, if you guys want to stick to the coast, sure, maybe I'll get some sort of disguise, or I'll wear a big mustache.
Well, I'm just thinking, since we've been with you, we've been in forested areas, and we haven't incurred this beast or any pirates, so maybe...
True, but I swore I... No, nothing. I'm just tired. I'm always tired. I see
things. Well, obviously things chase you. Obviously you may have, maybe you have seen it, right? But has it ever come, like, face-to-face and challenged you, or is it literally just following you and, like...
Not face to face, but I've seen it in the distance, and it's chased me. Hasn't caught up. Otherwise, I'd be dead.
And I'm sure if we see it, we'll know.
That's why I got Jojo. He was my guard dog. He let me know when it was around. And now that he's gone, I'm looking at you, Alex.
As you're talking, you walk by a building and it's just got this, like, giant lizard on the side of it.
There it is! It's just like waffles.
Okay, so you guys left the inn. Are you heading directly towards the map maker, the cartographer?
Listen, I would assume this is something that Maple and I would have already done. Even getting provisions for the trip, even for them, like getting all ready so we're ready to go when they're done.
100%, yeah. So
I should probably have that
already so you guys can kind of get out of Dodge faster. So
then there's one thing we'd still have to do, though. We still have to figure out our transportation. Are we walking?
We should get some horses, yeah. Go to the stable.
We should be able to get a proper cart and stuff here. We should see if we can find a blacksmith and stable and maybe, yeah, just get it all.
Okay.
Done at once.
Okay. So let's figure out what you did with the blacksmith and such first so that you know how much money you'll have. And
yes.
Go from there.
So what I wanted to do with the blacksmith, tell him, hey, you know, you guys aren't big fans of the Kren around here, are you?
The blacksmith that you found is actually a young woman. and which is strange with mainly only because it seems to be a male dominated profession, but she's got some very finely made crafted items hanging behind her, and she just spits the ground, says, "I hate the Kren. Oh, those cow loving son of worms. I rightfully hate the Kren." She spits the ground again. "Why? What's it to ya?"
Here, well, just before arriving in the city, we ran again. We were attacked, because obviously they like to just randomly attack people. And so, in response, we kind of killed all of them, including their captain, who had an incredibly ornate sword that I thought someone might like as a memento, as a fallen Kren captain. And then I'll pull it out, and I'll kind of, lay it across my arms, and it's pretty impressive, isn't it, for such a inferior.
She looks it over.
"I suppose you could say it's impressive. I could have done better, but..."
From what I see on their back wall, actually, I would have to agree. There's some pretty nice items there.
Aye, as would I. Perhaps I can interest you in purchasing some of these, but...
She looks at the sword and... Almost as if she's going to spit on the sword, then respect.
Fair enough. Some people wouldn't want anything to do with it. Fair enough. Some people would be like, "Yeah,
no. I didn't say I wanted nothing to do with it."
Okay, just...
I'll bite off you. If for no reason other than to melt it down and use it in some shit weapons.
I like you.
Is there anything on this that might be worth more than, if it was removed, or, what I'm trying to say is, I'm here to purchase some items. I might be able to get a better price for the sword elsewhere. Maybe some...
No. I'll give you a fair price. Just because I'm not going to do shit with it doesn't mean I won't give you the fair price. Make some fine horseshoes out of it. Some noble will purchase them. Don't worry about it. And that
I
way,
like your thinking. I like
the Kren sword can be trudged on all day. So what do you want for it? What would you like me to make?
Well, I was curious if maybe even a trade.
Alright.
I had some nice hand axes that, again, through a few battles and whatnot with Kren and whatnot else, those are not with me anymore. So I'm looking to upgrade my hand axes. Let's see. Shoot. Because to me, this sword looks like it's worth something, so I'm sure maybe we could trade for hand axes, or...
So do you want new hand axes, or do you want your current ones made finer?
I think these ones are quite simple. I think I would like a little bit more. Like, these are just like wooden handle, a little, or I would like something a little of better quality.
I've got something for you. She wanders in the back. So this blacksmith store is more so like a stall. So it's like open, you're still outside, but it's got kind of a tent over top, and she's got the bellows in the working area. But she does seem to have some kind of like back room or back attachment to the tent. She goes back there. And she comes back with two hand axes, and they're quite nice. So they're still wooden handles, but they're like a nice polished wood, clearly done by somebody who knew what they were doing, and the actual blades look very, very sharp, well polished, well kept. The metal looks like it was made, very, very fine craftsmanship. Okay. And she goes,
"And they're well balanced too." And she just does this and hucks it right, like, and the axe spinning head over head thunks into a booth across across the road from where
I'm
she
sold.
Is.
I was gonna say,
that's a good axe.
Where are you from?
I'm in love.
This old, like thin, skinny man comes out and was like,
Damn you, Brielle! What have I told you about throwing axes at me? She says, I've never hit you yet, old man. And he goes, yeah, I don't know if that's because you don't have good aim or because you have wonderful aim. I don't know if I want to know.
What better way to show a product or a, the potential?
Yeah, and she walks over and she just, like, gives it a couple pulls and clearly went pretty deep into the wood as well. And she walks back and just thunks it down into the desk, or not the desk, but the table or platform that she showed you on. She goes, aye, that's my finest, and I have two more where that one came from.
So you have four in total?
Yes.
Wow, because these are very nice. I haven't seen a hand axe like this in a while. This is definitely some. And you made this yourself?
I did. Every
piece. Impressive. Impressive. Okay.
Hey, just remember there, you also owe me a bow.
So, where were we?
Ignore my companion.
It's like, good point, good point. Also,
like,
now I know
we got a few
is...
other things to trade here or sell to you as well. So.
Right.
Yes, absolutely. Maybe we could just give us a price for kind of all of it as a all in one.
What are you guys going to attempt to sell to her?
One long sword, two chainmails.
Two long swords. How long do you have them?
Do I have one? Yeah, I traded. Remember? Cool.
Okay, I got two.
And a spear. If she wants them.
She looks over the wall to me, inspects each one, and says, well, I could do a few things for you. For the sword, and the armor, and the swords, and the spear, I could give you the four hand axes, and I could give you some coin on top of that. But if there are other items that you wish to trade for, I could be negotiated into it.
We do. I would also need a bow and some arrows. Maple here. Yeah, Maple, my cousin here. She's the one who would be looking for an arrow.
Ah, yes. A woman by my standards, a true woman. One killing more than she does talking. I like it. She just like gives this big grin.
Okay, looking at her, would I assume she's from a different area? Like, does she look more bigger?
So I'll give you a little bit of a description. So she has like this jet black hair that's kind of put into like almost like cornrow type stuff, and then she's got almost like a. It's not an uncommon skin tone, but you'd have to be like a farmer out in the sun a lot. So it's a little bit more tanned, but it looks a little bit more natural on her. And the accent, you've noticed, is just really all over the place with this girl. And it's pretty easy for all of you to pick up the fact that she probably has some underlying accent that she's trying desperately to cover up. So wherever she is from, she doesn't really want you to know.
All right.
Okay, out of that. Okay, now, another thing. We are actually in need, I know it's not very common, but we are in need of having some of our weapons silvered. And I know that is very expensive, but it's something that we actually...
It is. Normally I ask clients to bring me the silver to do so, because it's very difficult to procure. But I like you. I could do it for you. I would need a 10-day to get the silver, though. How long are you going to be in town?
Oh, unfortunately, we're just on our way out.
Oh, no, this is before...
Ah.
No, this
or
is...
would this be before? That's right.
Yeah.
This
would...
Yeah, that's right.
And you could have, in theory, taken care of this on day one if you'd like, so...
Right, okay. That's what we would have gotten done that, and then we would have gone fishing. And...
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. How many weapons are you looking to have silvered?
Well...
as much as cause... possible.
It depends on your coin.
That's right. Personally, I would like two of these hand axes to be silvered.
I could give you one for the price of the trade of all your equipment. So I could give you the four hand axes and one of them silvered in exchange for what you've given me here.
That's pretty badass. Okay.
And that's
otherwise.
I'll be honest with you. That's a really good deal. And I'm only doing it because I like your companion here. She kind of points at Maple again.
Well, and actually, and now that I mentioned it, if any of us are going to have a silvered weapon, I would like it to be Maple. So maybe we could silver her weapon?
What weapon are you using?
I have this long sword.
Ah, yes, long sword. Her accent like clearly switches again there. A lot more metal to cover there with that. I couldn't do it for the same.
Or perhaps the spear and maybe a couple daggers?
If the daggers aren't, a stretch of the word dagger, then I could do a spear tip and two daggers for the same price as that hand axe.
Is that... cool,
I personally would be willing. That sounds good to me. Because again, in the future, obviously, I want my weapon silvered too. But let's say one of my hand axes silvered plus two of her daggers. How much? Like, what would the difference be for that?
Can I see the daggers?
Sure. I have a medium and a large one.
She looks at them. I'll tell you what, I'll give you the labor on that for free, but even then, I'm gonna need to, just to procure the silver, I'd likely need at least 50 gold pieces, if not 60.
How about two spear tips, then?
I could do two spear tips. Included. Two spear tips and a hand axe, plus the four hand axes, in exchange for what you've given me here.
I think that's pretty solid.
That's awesome.
What is being silvered? Is just the spear tips? Or the daggers?
Two spears and you get a hand axe.
And I get a hand axe. Right. And to have a second-hand axe, you'd say that probably be around 50 gold or something?
Yeah, probably in that range. Maybe a little bit less if I can get a good deal, but... Oh.
Sold.
Good deal. Yes.
And I will hand her the 50 gold and said, when we come to pick it up, any more or less, you know.
All right, thank you. And she says, yes, just drop by in a 10-day, I'll have it all ready for you. Her accent switches again.
And I don't mean to be rude at all, but where are you from? I'm from the north, some of the tribes up there, but I can't quite place. Yeah,
it's very intriguing. You with some fairly she's gonna squint her eyes at you.
It's none of my business. I certainly don't have to answer. I just...
Who's asking? Who's asking? Just you? What do you care?
Oh, I was just curious. I meant no offense.
Well, as your companion knows, it's rude to ask a lady where she comes from.
Fair enough.
Forgive my cousin. He's still looking for true love, I think.
He's got a thing for strong, powerful women. What can I say?
You're not going to find it here! I mean, you're not going to find it here. I assure you.
Again, it was curiosity. We're leaving town. It's not like I'm staying here.
All right. You don't have to pull my leg. I'll tell ya. Twisted my arm, aren't ya? I'm from a place most people don't really know about, and my accent most people really don't like, so I try to cover it up, but I'm shit at it. So this is what I normally sound like. Do you think less of me now?
No.
I can't imagine why.
Out of game, yeah. Is she a dwarf?
She's quite short, so not that your characters may have never seen a dwarf before, but out of game, yes, yeah, she is certainly a dwarf.
Okay. I was kind of thinking
but
that. Okay.
Dwarves don't live in cities.
All
like
the
they
humans
are,
look the same.
They're like near mythical creatures, right? So
and
she,
they're Irish.
I think she's just a really strange human.
Once she starts speaking, with her accent, like normally, Can just because I have had dealings with dwarves in my past, can I differentiate like if she's, you know, like from the mountains or if she's, you know, from hills or like
give me an intelligence check and history if you have it.
So and I know about them more through people, but the dwarves mostly went to her mountain village, and they stayed away from the coast for her, so I haven't 13. Had as much as...
Okay.
Intelligence 13, and history is 18.
Okay, awesome. The defining thing about her is that she has this tan skin. Most dwarves, because they're underground most of their life, are actually not pale. But their skin is more tempered by the forge than it is by sunlight, if you know what I mean? So they're almost more dirty than they are tan most of the time.
Permanent soot.
Yeah, permanent soot. Yeah, it's just stuck on there. But she looks like she's been out in the sun. So meaning one of two things. She's just a normal dwarf that traveled when she was very young, very possibly. Or she's from a culture of dwarves you've probably never interacted with, but have certainly heard of, that are actually far to the south. And instead of living in mountains, they actually live in hills primarily. So they don't like dig down to mine. They actually are known to sometimes have above ground settlements.
Open pit mines.
Yeah. Actually, in some cases, they're like more quarry dwarves than they are like deep down mining. I mean, they're still, you know, throwing picks at something because, you know, stereotypes.
Less chance of waking up some deep ancient evil, though, if you're just scratching the surface.
Yeah.
So having learned that... Jack, just another point, sir. Yo, Jack, no.
I just want to, like, as we leave, I'm just going to say, like, a generic goodbye, but in Dwarvish.
Okay. Her eyes just kind of go wide, and she looks around.
I'll just do a little nod and, like, see you in a 10-day.
And she goes, there's no dwarves here! You don't have to say there's dwarves here!
I mean, like,
I don't even know what a dwarf is. Stop saying.
I'll just kind of look around and be like, where's the dwarves?
She just kind of like still wide eyes you as you walk away.
There goes my deposit.
All right. So you leave the blacksmith. Are you heading to the map maker after this?
Yeah.
We would have gone to the Mapmaker, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, and before we go any further, hi, Animeus. welcome back.
Stalking in the shadows, waiting to strike.
Yeah, exactly.
He's been following us the whole time. He knows what's going on.
An hour and a half sequence of role-playing shopkeeps just for it to end in being stabbed to death.
Like, with a shiv.
A sharpened bow.
All right. Yes, let's go find a cartographer or a map thingy guy.
Fantastic. Okay. So you find the shop that the innkeeper had suggested.
Mm-hmm. Oh, what was his name again? Shoot.
Jeffrey.
Oh, not Jeremy.
Joffrey, no.
Oops.
All right. So you go to the shop that he identified, and while it makes total sense, the path he identified, you didn't really realize it was going to bring you to the edge of the water. So this is actually a shop that sits right near the docks, because again, Elioth sits right on that bay, right? And this is the first time you've really headed to the bay in this area, and just you're immediately taken aback, especially if you guys, I mean, I know you're on the coast, so determine how much you want from this, but there are huge ships here. Like, if you don't know what a galley is, this is what you imagine Pythagoras was describing, even though that happens in the future. This is what I'm sure
you guys
have heard that in the past. So, like, you always heard these stories of these huge boats. That's what you imagine they might be. Some of these things have sails that are larger than buildings you've seen. So, like, take it back.
While we're here, can I see if we see any Viking ships? Like, any like, longboats or anything of that style? Just out of curiosity, because there shouldn't be anyone here that we know of, because my family's all dead now, but,
You make a point of taking a quick look along the dock on the bay, and yeah, no, it doesn't appear that there are any, like, longboats or anything meant for kind of long distance as far as, you know, barbarian or Viking-esque expos was concerned. Most of these are quite foreign.
Okay. Yeah, my village would have had boats coming, like we did do trade and a lot of fishing, but nothing of this scale, right? I mean, yeah, more local northern trade.
So you get to the shop that's sitting on the edge of the water, and as you enter, you walk in to see a bald man who's got several rings in his right ear, and he's like missing several teeth. He gives you a big hearty grin when you walk in, and he's got just this little like pointed, like, devil's beard kind of thing on his chin. He says, "Customers!" And he walks up and he attempts to give you a hug, Almagar.
Great, a car salesman.
are you gonna let him?
I'm just gonna stand there kind of like, I'll let him, but sure. I'm not gonna really
but
hug
not,
him
like,
back.
Reciprocating, yeah. He like gives you a hug and pats you on the back. Maple, he goes to do the exact same thing.
I'll just stand there awkwardly, like I don't know what to do. I'm just, I don't want to offend anyone. Like, we need supplies, so I'm just like, yeah, okay, but I'm like totally awkward about it.
Okay, yeah. So he gives you a hug too, pats you on the back. He goes, come on, I know exactly what you're looking for, and he brings you over to his desk and he pulls out this map. And he rolls it out, and it's like of some just area you've never seen. It's like an island, and it's got water around it. And he goes, this here is an isle that I traveled to not but 5 years ago. I know this is what you seek. I'll tell you what, 100 gold pieces. And he just sits there and smiles. No, not your liking, as you don't, like, respond immediately. He rolls up, no, I was just kidding. But a jest! And he, like, puts it down. And he takes out another one. He rolls, I see you are fine, discerning people. He rolls out another map. This is when I travel to the south.
As he's unrolling it, I'll be like, we were told to come here by Jeffrey from the inn?
Ah, from the Cloak and Beggar! Yes, Jeffrey, a good friend of mine.
He's been a very, very good host. Yes.
Yes, always an excellent host. This guy's just like, You'll notice, so to give a little more description, you know, now that he's like walked around and hugged you, he's wearing like pirate pants, so they've got like the puffy kind of tied up, like not quite the ankle, but a little bit higher. And he's wearing this pretty frilly shirt that's cut open at the chest. And by cut open, I mean it wasn't made to be like this. Like somebody just took a knife to it and sawed it open. He's got like his man meat hair just like hanging out of it, and yeah, he looks pretty pleased. He says, "Yes, Jeffrey. Yes. Oh, I understand. He pulls back the island map and rolls it. You did want this one, but you want Jeffrey's price. I understand. 90 gold pieces. Special price just for you, friends of Jeffrey. I know, I'll go out of business if I do it. I understand, but you know what? Friends of Jeffrey are friends of mine."
Fucking love
this guy. While we do appreciate the Jeffrey discount, we actually just need a map of the area, like the general area around us, as maybe to like towards the coast, more southwest, maybe.
Oh.
Do you have like a more of a generic?
He rolls it up, takes out another.
We're not from the area, so we're having a little trouble finding our way around. It'd be much better if we actually knew what the next town was going to be down the road.
Fair enough. He unrolls it and kind of glances up at you a couple times, and then like kind of half rolls it again, and then positions his arm so that you can see the map, but all you can see is the city you're currently in. And he says, "You know, friends of Jeffrey are always friends of mine, but you wouldn't happen just be coming in here looking to purchase a map so you can see where you're going next, are you? I've had that before, and let me tell you, this is a lifetime's worth of work. Do you know how long it takes to walk and write down what you see and then translate that to a map? It's a long time. I'm old. I'm tired."
I'm gonna look at him in all honesty, like the most serious face, and be like, "Do you just do maps?"
"It's all I do. Maps. It's my whole life, my life's work, my parents' work, their parents' work. We used to be sailors, apparently, one point in time. Then someone's like, let's map our journeys, and here I am, hundreds of years later." What a life.
Why don't you write a story about making maps?
That would be interesting. Then you could hear tales of different... from a different perspective than the regular adventurer would like.
Most of the time I'm so occupied with walking or writing what I'm walking on or copying what I've written down based off of what I've walked on. Never really thought of taking the time to write a book about my journeys. But yes, perhaps I should. That's an excellent idea. Just for that idea, I will take 2 gold pieces off of any map you wish to buy. I'm not an unreasonable man.
Unfortunately, we are not exactly prosperous travelers ourselves. We're actually just, you know, long story short, you know, lots of trouble and turmoil, you know, entire families and villages completely destroyed, trying to find a new home. Anyway, we have some gold, but I mean, I certainly can't be spending $100 on a map.
Well, we might be able to work something out. I always find a way to work things out. Because I like to help friends, and I think that we are getting along wonderfully. You're old.
Sorry, can I do like some sort of check? Like, did he take anything off of me? Or like, does my quaint feel lighter or something?
Take a look at yourself. No, nothing's missing.
It's like after that hug, we're like, wait a minute.
Yeah, wait. Yeah.
What did you do with my pride?
He says, "So occasionally, I do other things when I'm out mapping. So, as you imagine, once you've mapped many things, you only really need to map them once unless there's something change, you know, volcano erupts or something, but it happens so rarely. So really, I've mapped most everything, but I still like to go out just to double-check the consistency of some of the things I've done. But that can be quite boring, you can imagine, if everything turns out A-okay. So, what I do is I occasionally take on work. Well, one of my old friends approached me to take on some work, and I didn't really take to it, only because it didn't require me to travel. It's taking place right in this city, apparently. But I'm really obligated to help this friend out. He works for someone that at some point really made a big, big difference, a big impact in my family's life. And it's quite simple, I promise. You don't really need to do much about it. But there's someone who apparently has made their way to this city that my friend would just like to know their whereabouts. If you could do that for me, I would happily exchange a map of some kind. Maybe not this map, as he rolls up the very large one, but an area map of somewhere in our area. And all you have to do is find this person. And maybe, if the person is in the right circumstance, deal with them.
Okay, well... Guys, I'll kind of just take a look around. Is there anyone else in this
shop? No, it's empty.
Okay, I'm like, well, give us a little bit more details here. Who would we be looking for? Is it just one man, or is it a woman, a group?
Just a man, although apparently he may have comrades. I don't know. But the deal here is that if he has friends around and you feel uncomfortable dealing with it, you don't have to. You don't have to. But if he's alone, we would really like it if you could deal with it. If you understand what I'm saying. And if he's not alone, it would be very convenient if you could get him alone and then deal with it. Now, this will be on Sailor's honor, so of course if you can't manage that, I'll believe you. But as I don't rightfully believe you're sailors, I just preferred if you dealt with it. But if you do this, yes, I'll exchange a map free of charge. Wouldn't even take you a day's work.
And they're here in the city?
Supposedly. And if you can't find them, no harm done. I mean, I won't be able to give you a map, but you know. Chance for free.
It's an intriguing offer.
Who are we looking for?
We have a deal? I can't give you the details, and I hope you understand. You are my friends, my dear, dearest, dear, endearing friends, but I can't give you details until you say yes. Sailor's honor.
Oh, with Sailor's honor, would you give us your name first, then?
Oh, yes. My name is Tarkin. Tarkin Bloodsail. No, I'm just kidding. Bloodsail is such a dramatic name. Maybe if I write a book, that's the name I'll give myself. My name truly is Tarkin. I've never really had a last name, to be honest. Everyone just refers to me as Tarkin. It's been my way my whole life. But doesn't Bloodsail go well with Tarkin? Like, doesn't just... Oh, the feared pirate Tarkin Bloodsail.
It does sound pretty fearsome.
Yes. I think tales will be told. Especially when I write this book.
Captain Bloodstorm. These are some pretty impressive ships. I mean, I come from a fishing village and small trade, and not even close to that size of her.
Mere trading ships. You've seen nothing until you've seen a fully equipped galley with ballistae manning the decks, 100-man crews, 40 of which need to rein in sails. You have never seen anything until a mast creaks with the wind of thousands of pounds of pressure. Until you've seen that, you've seen nothing. But yes, they can be impressive if you've never seen a ship.
Well then.
So what do they normally trade in this area? Like, is this a...
Oh, all sorts of things. Aeleoth is not a very, how do you put it? Independent city. They don't really have the ability, well, the ability is a light term. They don't have the want, perhaps, to farm for themselves, or grow crops, or mine, or anything of that. Yes, but I'm sure if you traveled here not by boat, you walked through the golden fields on the road here.
Yes, that was, yeah.
To many cultures,
that overgrown golden grass is worth a strange amount of money in trade, and it grows extremely quickly, which is why it's not even protected. So most people in Aeleas, which is why everyone's so pleased with themselves, if they need to make a trade, they just go harvest some of the golden grass and trade for almost everything. And then they try and sell it to unsuspecting travelers that make their way through. Now, don't get me wrong, many people have honest jobs here, but that's the general gist of it. Although now they're talking about having people require licenses to cut it down. I don't know how you're going to control an area that large, but so be it. Let the nobles squabble, right? Am I right?
Yeah. Yeah. Just kind of looking at Scoticus like, Elmagar, like, yeah, we should,
Wait. Let me, before you just leave without taking my deal, let me at least show you an example of the size of map I would give you. And he turns around, and can you both give me a perception check, please? As he stands kind of on his tippy toes and leans up to grab a map that he has up on the wall.
Four.
What'd you get, Scott?
Two.
Oh, wait, sorry, I did the math. Six.
All right.
Not much better, but yeah.
Well, no, six is quite a bit better. It really wasn't too difficult to identify what you need to identify. So as he pulls it down, you'll see as his sleeve drops further down his arm, he's got a tattoo on his left arm. It's the color red, but you can't make out what it is before he pulls down his sleeve again.
It's a map of the area. Cut his arm off.
He takes out this map, and he rolls it out, and it's like this big. Like, it's a little itty-bitty little map you can hold in like one hand and still see the whole thing. And it looks like it's dyed on some leather. It's not even on parchment or anything. But he says, this is an example of a map I could give you. This is the one for the immediate area. And to give you guys context, it's about the size of that map that I posted on Facebook. At least for what it includes. Like, it's about that large. He says, I have maps not just for this area, but in other areas approximately this size. And normally I would sell this for about 65 gold pieces. So, I mean, if you're willing to do this minor work for me, I would greatly appreciate it. And my employer and my friend would also greatly appreciate it. And perhaps, who knows, there could be future employment for you down the road.
Normally, I would take up your offer so quickly.
What hesitations do you have, my friend?
We are under very strict, guard, but we are only here for a short time, and in that time it's basically made it very clear to us that we're supposed to, not to cause any trouble, to lay low, and we'd be dealt with quite sternly, quite quickly. And this is coming from the tower. I don't know your deals with them, but
I'll tell you what. As a friend, I'll give you the description of this character. If you happen to find him, come to me once you've dealt with him, and I'll give you a map. Sailor's honor. If you don't pursue it, no harm done. But I would highly suggest trying to pursue it. I think it'll be worth more to you than just a map.
Well, considering I don't have 60 gold, that probably, yeah.
So what you're saying is I don't need to have my men rob you on the way out? I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Yeah, they probably would have
fun. I kind of just glance over at Elmagar like, with that look like, I don't think he was kidding.
Does it sound like a fair deal? Fair trade?
Sure, give them the description, and if we happen to...
Yes, sir. Yeah, we certainly...
...character, right. We can see what we
do. You should be here long enough to maybe...
We are in need of a map, if we can get it one way or another.
The man is a young gentleman. Looks quite tired all the time, I've told. But most identifying fact about him is that he carries quite an interesting weapon with him. It is a rapier. And the most identifying thing about it is that it's red.
Well, that should be.
She doesn't go anywhere without it. I assure you of that. So if you see him out the red rapier, just deal with him. And I can assure you that it's who you are looking for.
All right.
And he goes into a few other details, clearly describing Pythagoras.
Do we pick up on this as he's telling us this?
Oh, yeah, 100%. Well, like, as soon as he says red rapier and, like, says tired all the time, you're like, oh, shit. And he says, and apparently he's also traveling with some quite brutish fellows that just enforce his will, and I've been told worship him like a god. So, you know, blind devotion can be threatening. I would just try and take him away from the group to be safe. I mean, you look like you can deal with yourselves, admittedly, but... who am I to say? I don't want you to be hurt. We're new friends.
I was going to say, this, I mean, the rapier is red, right? It's not like, yes.
I've never seen one as fine. And it is ornate. It is a beautiful weapon. Extraordinary.
Oh, okay. All right. I'm just making sure it's just a regular, at least it's not going to, like, hurt me extra if I do get stabbed.
No,
it's not like it's going to...
No more than a piece of metal being thrust through your heart by a pirate on the winds, on the deck of a great ship, finding and forging his way through the seas would hurt you.
Oh, king of the world, that's what you'd be. King of the world up there.
Okay, well, we should probably get going. You still got a little bit more errands to do here, and now we gotta keep an eye out for this guy, so better get on.
Well, if he's here, I'm sure we can find him.
Sounds good. Thank you, friends.
Yes, thank you.
You big toothless friend.
And so your friends are outside Front Street. Is there like a word, password to...
No.
We're good?
No. He raps like 3 times on the wall.
Oh my god. Oh, I'm going to go give Jeffrey a piece of my mind.
Meanwhile, 10 days later...
Yeah, so you guys, is there any other shops or anything else you needed to shop at while you were out and about? I mean, you got provisions and stuff, I'm assuming. For every day's worth... Holy shit. For every day's... Sorry, I just threw a die. Every day's worth of rations, it will cost you about 5 gold pieces, so however many rations you want to carry on your person, deduct that times...
I don't think we'll pick up any rations until we have to go, because we don't know how long the guys are going to be, or if we even need to pick up rations for them. They might come back dead, so...
Makes sense.
So I think, we'll hold off on that.
Think of all the extra rations we'd have if they didn't survive the ritual.
Fair enough. Yeah, okay.
Just a couple extra bodies outside the inn next time you come back.
Looks
like they're done.
If it makes you feel any better, though... We'd get over it, so it's don't feel bad that you're deserting us.
During the week, I'd like to keep an eye out, like, just around, like, maybe I'll do sweeps of the market area or whatever, but I want to see if I can find either another couple dogs for like, I don't care if they're puppies and have to grow into the sled dog role. But maybe not dogs, like maybe something of like a, just like a medium sized animal that could pull the sled. I don't know, maybe like a boar or some foreign animal. I don't know, something cool though. Sure. Something a little bit meaty and hardy, just because I am a barbarian and I don't want, like, you know.
2 house cats.
Exactly. I don't want a house cat. I thought about a bear, and it won't work because it's winter. They're just going to go and hibernate on us.
Yeah. Very true. Sure. So you stop by the market, and there aren't a whole lot of animals being sold here. The ones that are being sold by some very, very exotic gentlemen speaking in very thick accents. And these things are like large cats. And they have, like, some of them are spotted, and some of them are, like, sleek jet black. And every time somebody walks by, they're just like, as they, like, claw at the cage. But that's really all you see. I mean, if you're interested in those, you could definitely have a discussion with them.
Yeah, I doubt those are going to go for 5 gold.
No, I don't think those would be. They'd get freaked out and jump up a tree or something, and there you go, like, up a tree with the sled.
Yeah. Otherwise, for medium-sized creatures, they're mainly dead and being sold as food.
Myself, too, what I was thinking of doing during this 10-day, I still need to keep active and whatnot, so I was going to see about...
We're going to go
voluntary
hunting.
And
What's we're that? Going fishing, and we're going to go hunting. Because we need to... I want to see... I have a little bit out of the group loot. I'm just going to splurge and see if I can find some someone who sells some traps.
And get some more traps. Yeah, I was going to say, if there's that, I was going to just try to do stuff physical. Like, if I see people stacking crates, I'll just go and help them.
No,
or, you
we,
know, like, someone's
need...
building fence posts to put a wall.
Save that energy, and we need to go harvest some gold grass. Yeah.
Get a cart and go harvest some.
We got the sled. You can pull that. There's some sacks on it.
That's not the thing. Are we just free to leave the city back and forth, or I'm guessing we probably stay within the walls?
Yeah,
while we're
there was no real guidelines placed on YouTube. Mm-hmm. Like, they put you up in an inn, assuming that you're going to wait for your comrades,
yeah,
but they never said you had to stay here.
Yeah,
or
they just didn't want
like
us
that.
In the tower.
Yeah, essentially. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but yeah. So if you want to purchase some hunting traps, you certainly can. Each hunting trap.
I'll try and haggle.
Sure. Yeah. Give me a charisma check. Or actually persuasion if you have it.
Ten.
Okay. You don't do so well. The person you talk to that has traps really doesn't want to negotiate you too much, argues that the price he's charging is just compensates for the metal, even though you know it's total bullshit. But yeah, each trap costs 8 gold pieces.
Eight,
yeah.
I'll buy two.
Okay, all right. So you pick up two large hunting traps. Okay, so you grab some traps. You do some hunting and some fishing. You guys are fairly successful. You get enough, you know, for probably a few days worth of food from your exploits, but. Yeah, and I'm assuming you want to collect those weapons from the blacksmith prior to meeting up. Like, he probably would have gone in the morning, kind of thing. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So yeah, you go and the woman greets you, and she, you know, gives you your weapons, plate and silver, and says, you know, may they serve you well, and you know, I'm not going to ask why you need them silver plated, but hey, enjoy.
Hey, if you asked, I would answer.
well, I'm not gonna.
Were those the other hand axes? But that we didn't trade those in, did we? I meant to trade those ones in for the newer ones with the rest of the loot. That part doesn't make a difference.
Sorry, I kind of assumed that those were being traded as well.
Okay,
but
good.
I mean,
good.
It wouldn't have made a huge difference to the value of the sale. So either way.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. So, fast forward. You guys are taking care of these activities. All four of you are together again.
And that's meeting. Why they're never goats. All right.
Yeah.
So.
Exactly. Leaving the inn, and I guess we'll also have to assume that Jeffrey told you guys about the map person prior to the four of you getting together. I realize that was a little blip in my brain there. I apologize. But yeah.
Right.
Anyways. Yeah.
So our conversation would have gone a little bit different.
A little bit.
Obviously, we would have told Pythag, oh, that's something we should do now. Like, tell Pythag, you know.
Well, I'm pretty sure our memories jogged now.
It's like a Pulp Fiction movie. It's all cut up differently.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's been a week and we've been drinking the morning. So, you know.
Exactly.
It didn't
Everybody's
really.
Stressed out.
Yeah. We just.
I'm drunk.
But as soon as Pythagoras did mention that this thing, you know, I would have mentioned, oh, well, they're here, they know you're here, and they are actually looking for you.
And don't go to the map maker. He works for them.
Don't even go to the docks, which have nice ships, as you mentioned.
What was his name?
Tarkin.
Do I know who Tarkin is?
Give me an intelligence check, just to see if there's anything that you remember.
9.
He didn't have any teeth, and he was bald, had some piercings. Oh,
like hug.
On his left arm, he had a tattoo.
It was red. Oh wait, I didn't know that.
Yeah, you saw it, didn't you?
Did it happen to be?
I don't think I was perceptive enough.
No, it was just you that noticed the maple.
Oh, well.
And you barely noticed it. You just noticed big red head.
Red. I don't know what it was, but kind of.
Yeah, Tarkin doesn't ring a bell to you at all, Pyre.
No.
But the exact, I don't know what it means, but he said something like he swore on the, what was it, sailor's code or something he said there, Almagar, that he would help us out if we could take care of it. And so,
hey, yeah. Pythagoras, all we have to do is take care of you and we get a free map. How do you like that?
I hate you, Almagar.
Well, trust me. If I wanted that free map, you would have already been dead. Obviously. Obviously, I value enough. You more than a map.
You are very big. Well, that sounds like maybe the Red Lotus? Let's not go there.
Well, I would assume, considering the story you just told us, that,
why I don't like water.
Which is funny, because we're already saying how we really need to get her to dodge, but now we really need to get her to dodge.
I'm also thinking when we leave tonight, we shouldn't leave all together. Like, maybe leave in a couple pairs or something. Like, a few, a little bit of time away from one another.
Yeah.
Good thing. And we still don't have a map.
You should be disguised.
Haven't taken care of.
You should be disguised.
I was planning on it, actually. I wanted to go to a tailor.
Because he said they were looking for a gentleman who looks tired all the time. So it's a good thing you got some rest.
Yeah, I'm refreshed.
And carries a red rapier. They said it was very distinct. We would know. So if I were you, you might want to keep that tucked away while we're around here.
And I will put that away and pull out my short sword instead.
Yeah, I was going to say, I should just keep out the short sword for now.
Oh! I wonder if our blacksmith could make a... I don't think he could make a red forgery of that that would be convincing even to
It's probably one of a kind. I don't know about that.
Might have been so just some poor dude.
No, we could totally go back and ask her about it, though. It doesn't have to be done now, but for future reference, something we could pool our money into.
That would be pretty good, actually. You could end up trading that for a free map or even selling it off.
The only thing is, again...
We found some sucker and stabbed him in an alley, and... Hey, look it. He actually had a red rapier on him. This must be the guy they were talking about, right?
And he said we just had to take care of him. He said nothing about bringing the sword back, did he? The cartographer? He didn't say bring the sword back. He just said take care of him.
He just said he would appreciate
if we had the red. If we had the red rapier, that would be proof that we took care of him. But we wouldn't. Oh no, he probably would have lots of friends waiting to take it from us. Not that they could, but they'd certainly try.
I kind of miss Animaeus.
Anyway. What would Animaeus do? Actually, what we should do, great idea, this whole maybe try to make kind of a forgery, but let's not do it here, because as much as I would trust this, we mention this sword or rapier to anyone, I'm sure they'll find it. So, the next city, next town, we'll kind of think about.
Well, good to know, at least. Don't make any deals with that guy.
I wasn't planning on it.
Which is another reason why you probably shouldn't go back to the inn either.
Which is funny, because we knew it was you that they were talking about, and then you tell us the story about. Then you tell us the story, and it makes perfect sense.
Now we know why they want you dead.
Is Joffrey looking at me kind of shifty? Like, he knows who I am? Or, I mean, Jeffrey. Sorry, not Joffrey.
Jeffrey? Oh, shit. Jeffrey? Yeah, sorry. I was like...
Come on, James, we're in the
No, Jeffrey doesn't seem to mind you at all. In fact, he's been very, very friendly to you since you guys came to the inn, so... Yeah.
And you know what? I think as far as map, we can worry about a map down the road, too. We know the area enough to get... Even Briac, I'm sure we can.
Well, I'm sure between my sense of direction out in the woods and Aeleas and everyone, we've been doing fine.
And if we have to, we'll find a piece of parchment or something and just have people tell, it doesn't have to be to scale, tell people, hey, what's the next town to the west? Oh, okay. You know, we can make our own map. I just want to know what the next town is before I get there. And I have to ask people everywhere, you know. Oh, well, we'll figure it out. Let's get out of here.
All right, so you guys are going to leave the city?
I think
I'd like to go to a stable.
Other than rations.
Yeah, get some food.
And I'd like to go to a stable.
Okay. Alright, so you guys get some food, and, sorry, you had mentioned a tailor?
Yeah, actually, I wanted to go to a tailor as well, real quick.
Okay. Alright.
I'll go with...
There.
Yeah.
What's that?
Is there anything in particular you're looking for, tailor?
That cloaker that I skinned. I wanted to get it, kind of form-fitted to me a little bit more.
Okay. Offers to do it for you, but he would need to hang on to it for a day. So if you could come back the next morning, he'd be able to have it done for you.
Nope. Then the stables would be the other place. So.
Okay. Yep, so you arrive at the stables. There's a young stable boy there just cleaning some excrement in the hay. And he looks at a few of you and kind of apathetically says, yeah, what? You picking up a horse?
Yeah.
Yes.
Clearly, yeah.
Yes, from the tower. Okay.
Alright, well, we need the pickup fee. What's the name of your horse, and what's your name?
We don't have names for our horses.
We require you to give a name, sir. I need to know whatever name you gave us for your horse to retrieve your horse.
Name something? Did you name something, Almagar?
Joffrey, isn't that right?
Right, yeah. Yeah, Joffrey, the horse.
It says... Maybe it went to a different stable. There's a few of them in town. I don't have a horse named Joffrey.
We were told we could get horses. They were supplied from the tower. We were told they would have some waiting here for us. We didn't actually book in any horses.
No one told me nothing. I can't give any horses away unless someone's told me something.
So I should just go back to the tower then and tell them you wouldn't help us out after they gave orders we could get some horses here.
Are you trying to intimidate them?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay, we need intimidation, or if you don't have intimidation, charisma.
Actually, can I use intimidation too, and I'll just kind of stand at my, you know, shoulders?
Yeah, go for it. Yeah, you can give an intimidation as well.
12.
Okay.
I was so intimidated, I think I peed a little. Natural 1 plus my intimidation. No. I'm like,
oh,
huh.
Man.
Elmgar is like backing away from me, like I'm gonna get ready to.
I'm a little teapot.
He kind of looks to you at first, Maple, and takes like a step back, and he looks over to Almagar, and Almagar is just like making some like face. He's trying to be like scary or something.
That's some horseshit.
And kid goes, look, go off the tower if you want. They can't do anything. If I haven't been told about the horses, I can't give you horses. I can sell you horses if that's what you're trying to trying to get at here.
How much?
Oh, normally we would. Like, what kind of? We have the money. We could buy a horse right now. We were just told to come and get a horse.
I mean, I would go back to the tower and talk to him then, but otherwise I can sell you one.
Yeah. Okay.
Are all the horses, like, right there in the room with us, or...?
There's a few stalls where you can see them, but it's an enclosed stable, so, like, there's a few horses in stalls, but you'd have to actually go inside to see the rest of them.
And are there other stables?
Oh, yeah, there's other stables in town.
Sure, maybe
we just
came to the wrong stable.
Well,
this kid, I mean, that's fine. We'll go check the other stables, and if not, we'll just let Elbrock know that, you know, you guys were unwilling to help us out. That's okay.
Yeah, I'm sure whoever that is should be able to straighten it away right for you.
I'll just give him, like, a glare, not trying to intimidate, but just, like, not backing down from him being stubborn either. Just like, eh, no, we'll go spend our money somewhere else.
Enough. Listen, motherfucker, you give us a horse right now or I'll fucking kill you right where you stand.
Did you actually say that?
Yeah, I say that.
Okay, give me intimidation.
Oh boy. Let's see. So, I don't have intimidation, so let's roll
charisma. So, charisma.
7? Yes, you take negative.
He goes, oh, right away! Let me grab your horse. He walks over to the stall.
And
he leans down and, like, grabs some of the hay and goes, here it is!
Almagar is gonna laugh.
Thank
you for your assistance.
Bugger off before I go get the guards that my master gives to guard the stable. You're not getting a horse.
Alright, let's go to another table.
I'm gonna say, yeah, we are leaving now. I'm gonna flip him a silver. And, yeah, that was so worth it. And now I'm gonna walk out.
Fuck.
Sorry, he's our bar. He's just here for entertainment.
Yeah. You just kind of
under my breath as we're walking out,
like standing on this pitchfork.
So, until these magics actually do come back, Pythagoras, you're just our bard. I was like, okay, enough. Let's go fight some horses.
All right, so you guys going to another stable?
Yeah.
All right, so you approach another stable with. A little bit of an older guy, and he's, like, brushing down a horse.
Now, out of game, did the tower actually tell us we could just get... I think I remember hearing that. Or were we literally just trying to steal a horse?
I was just trying to steal a horse.
Oh.
I kind of thought legit that, yeah, maybe someone did say that.
They told us we could get horses in the city, but they never said they would support. They said they would try and help us out. They would supply the inn and all of that for us, but...
Because maybe if we can get a smaller cart, like, that it could be pulled with one horse, I mean... I guess the other one was only one horse,
too. It doesn't have to be a horse to pull a cart. We could get, like, a mule or a donkey or something. They're a little bit cheaper than horses.
All right, listen up, motherfucker! You give me a horse right... No, I'm not going to do that.
Like, maybe you should be making a scene right now. There are people here looking for you. You should be trying on the down low.
It's hard to get used to this, okay? I've been feeling weird, and now it's gone, and I... Yeah, whatever.
Don't make me pull up my prized pirate red rapier.
Waves it around for everyone to see.
What's your deal, Almagar? Why are you always making fun of me now? Huh? Why are you always making fun of me? Antimaeus wouldn't have let you do this.
Sorry, it's how I cope after almost losing you. I'm sorry. I've lost somebody else. I just don't know how to cope with loss anymore.
Bring it
in.
Bring it in.
I will, yeah.
No time. You call out the hog? Yeah!
Also, there's a snap and Pi just goes, bolt.
Oh shit.
Fair hug.
I think we need to
roll for attack damage.
He can cast mend on himself, right?
Oh man. Okay. So you guys are at this other stable. The guy is rushing down the horse and says,
"Oh, how do you do on this fine day? My, do I love when the snow starts to fall. Brisk air is good air, I say.
come to purchase.
It's quieter too when it's, like, it seems like the sound's bad.
Yes, it does, doesn't it? It's just so settling. The city is such chaos most of the time, and most people hide in their homes when it starts to snow. I quite enjoy it. And what can I do for you?
We seek a trusty steed.
Ah, trusty steed. One for each of you, or one total? What are you looking for?
Don't know.
I think, ideally, we might be looking for a cart and a horse.
So just one, then?
I think one, because, again, there's enough we can ride on the wagon when we need to. And it depends. Sorry, we're thinking of a horse and a cart, but depending on the price, we may be able to get more, but I doubt
it. So how much is a horse?
Well, you're looking for a riding horse, I imagine, not just a draft horse.
So a draft horse, out of game, what is it?
Draft horse would pull a cart, do work in the field, but certainly not suitable for riding.
Okay.
And a riding horse, you could pull a cart, it just probably...
Oh yeah, certainly you could. They're still bred for labor, but they'll be able to maintain having someone atop them.
That would be nice, a little more versatile. When someone needs to run out and scout, maybe we could do that. And
sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, so for our riding horses, you'd be looking at about 100 gold pieces a horse.
Okay, do you have any donkeys?
Emaciated donkeys.
I do have donkeys as well. They're quite a bit more affordable, you could say. I could get you a donkey for a mere 11 gold pieces.
So could I take a look at the donkeys? Like, is there like a really sickly one that I could that he has or something?
Yeah, there's like
11 gold is too much? Come on.
There's like a thin old one there.
That one.
It like kind of lazily looks up to you.
How much for that one?
I think Pythagoras
you don't want that.
No.
He'll barely look apart. His prime days are right. To be honest, he's just sitting here eating food, occupying space. I'll give him to you for a gold piece.
I'll take him.
We'll take that.
All
right.
Group loot.
I give him a gold piece.
What is this gonna be our?
Well, that's party funds.
I get you. We're gonna make our own our trail rations. I got okay.
I don't think you get much out of this thing. As he gets led out of his stall, you can see like his ribs, it's like super skinny and just gaunt.
give him back.
You can see it's like hip bones in the back moving with every step it takes.
How about we just give the dollar to feed the thing? Or give him a gold.
Yeah, I give him a little piece of my ration, pet him.
Now, is there anything else here? Like, I look around, are there donkeys, horses, I mean...
Yeah, there's donkeys, there's horses, there's bigger horses, smaller horses, there's ponies, whole works. Yeah. As you pet it and give it food, it lets out a...
Aww. I'm gonna name it Necromancer.
What about wagons? Do you have any wagons here that are available?
Yeah, we do also carry wagons. We have a deal with one of the local cartwrights in town. So, yes, we sell wagons on his behalf.
Oh, okay. Anything in between a donkey and a horse? I'm just curious. Like
a mule?
I've got mules as well, yes, and I've also got ponies. Well, ponies aren't quite as suited to pulling things.
What do you think, Necromancer? Which one do you like? You'll make a good steed.
I don't know how much gold we have left in group loot, but I guess a horse and a wagon is probably out of our means.
We have 14 gold.
You're looking for a horse to... Well, what size of wagon are you looking for? Like, I have carts, I have wagons. Wagons are significantly larger.
A cart, basically. Like, that's what we have.
Something that'll carry just, maybe 3-4 people at a time. Nothing. It doesn't have to be big, but we are going to be carrying some goods with us. So more than just a cart, but
you could sit on the edge of a cart and get four people to sit on it. Although there wouldn't be much room in it if you have people's legs in there. But I could sell you a small cart for about 25 gold pieces. I could sell you a small cart. If you're looking for a wagon that you could actually sit that many people in comfortably, I could sell you one for about 65 gold pieces.
Okay. Trying to think if we had a... Oh, shit. Because I do still have some gold.
And then, as I said, if you're just looking for if you're looking for a riding horse to pull it, there are about 100 gold pieces. Although I could discount that for you a little bit if you were to buy a cart as well. I could bring that down to 75 gold pieces if you were to buy a cart with it. Or we have a draft horse, and I could, with the cart, give that to you for 50 gold pieces.
A draft horse and a cart for 50?
No, sorry. The horse itself would run 50, right, and then of course. The cart. Yes. Either 35 or 65, depending on what you need.
Okay. What do you guys think? Because we obviously can't afford this, so...
Dang, I can sell you a healthy mule or donkey for 8 gold pieces, one that's not on death's door, and then I could sell you a small cart for 25 gold pieces. Or sorry,
like, I can buy the cart if the group loot buys the... whatever to haul it. Donkey, I guess, is pretty much what we can afford.
Damn. I'm just curious if this guy cleans up after himself around the stable, or if there's like a pitchfork he could accidentally trip over and are on.
As this group's alignment just slowly.
And like I said, we're trying to get fuck out of here.
Antimaeus can't light people on fire, but you guys are allowed to make them trip and die on pitchforks.
I didn't think we're going to make them do anything.
He slipped on the snow. It was slippery.
Workplace accidents happen all the time.
And if Antimaeus was here, we could afford a cart and a horse.
Ouch. That's working. All right, so.
I assume he has it. I doubt it, but this year someone else got it. Which is possible.
Chaunted
would that up. Suck? Animaeus gets back to the cart.
He burnt the flesh bag. We know he made his mark.
That was fun.
Right. So friends, what can I do for you? Are you purchasing a horse? Are you purchasing a cart? Are you purchasing a donkey that will live past a day? What would you like to do?
Okay, I'm just going to mention. Would it? Sorry, sir. I hate to waste your time, but would we be better off? Maybe our friends in Brick, they might be able to.
You want average horses that, you know, have been inbred and such? Then yeah, sure, go to Bray.
Unfortunately, that's all we can afford.
I understand 8 gold pieces for some is a year's wage, but steeds, they last a lifetime. Their lifetime.
That's right.
Which is quite a long time.
So we had a cart. We had some misfortune, and now we find ourselves with it.
It's unfortunate. Tough times.
So could you just give us a moment?
Oh, of course. Yes. Of course.
Yes. Thank you. I'll just step back. We can get a small cart and a mule, or we can go to Briek and see what they can do.
I say we just burn this fucker down.
Just because we can't currently afford to buy, just
I think we got.
It's tempting.
We got a great steed right
here. We got the donkey here. We just need to go back and get some golden grass. Maybe we can trade with that real quick.
Need to what? Sorry, get gold. What?
Get the gold grass. People here will trade for that.
I don't think we have time. We need to get out of here.
He needs to get out of here.
And that donkey will never even make it to Briek.
Maybe.
So as fun as this is, let's go to Briek, and just forget.
Well, we got the sled. The donkey can pull the sled for now. There's nothing on it.
Guarantee you that donkey's gonna slow it. We're not gonna.
Ye of little faith. You know, people used to say that about me when I was young. I was sickly. Now look at me. This guy's a hero. Isn't that right, necromancer?
All right. This thing's not gonna do anything.
He kind of creeps me out. It's
starting to sound
little...
like the thing at the bottom
of
the
well. Yeah, I was just gonna say.
So, all right, tell you what, you guys figure it out. I'm gonna head to the front gate. I'll wait for you guys there, whatever you guys choose to do, because we can't afford a horse and a cart.
Cart or a horse. I think we should just leave. We can walk on our own 2 feet. We got the sled. Yeah. We can pull that.
And
all right.
And if we have to, we can see if we can get our old cart. It's not that far from Briek.
True.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sure Briek, we can get
out the spiders and the evil there anyway. So maybe, like they said, that we told the villagers it was there and they could have it, but no one wanted to go into that part of the forest anyway. So I bet it's still.
So we'd be doing them a favor by clearing that area. We could spend a few days in Briek just helping out again. I mean, that's...
Mm-hmm. Might be able to make the money up there and just pick up some steeds there. Heck, they might even give us some if we help out enough.
And again, I know we don't want to stay there over the winter. It's just, I don't think we...
No, just to get a little bit of gold so we can get some horses and get out.
Yeah. Yeah, I think they could be of more assistance.
Or else we are going to be stuck there for the winter.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's just head back to Briek then.
Okay, let's do it.
All right.
So you guys head to
Are we gonna head to the gate where the golden grass was?
That's probably the main.
That's the main gate
that leads south. So if you guys remember the map that I made there, do you know how I painted it like strangely yellow around Aeleoth? That's all the golden fields. So like it's a massive area that surrounds Aeleoth. So yeah, you're walking into the golden fields regardless where you're going.
Awesome.
Hey, if anything, we can. Well, if we had a cart, we could collect some and bring it to.
We have a sled that is empty.
Right. Yeah. Fill it up with what we can on the way, because that right full probably won't get us much, but it'll help Briek. I mean, it gives him a little bit more food, I guess.
Who knows? Maybe somebody smokes it out there.
Who knows what they do with it?
Smoke the golden grass.
Yeah, so I have two sacks in on the cart that I can, or on the sled that we can fill up with that grass. Does anyone have anything else?
Nope. That's why I figured we don't really need a cart or a wagon. We don't even have anything, so.
Yeah.
And if we have rope with us, we can always tie it in some little bushel thing to carry it on our backs. But again, I don't know. I could try it, but.
I'll fill two sacks worth of the hay, or grass, or whatever it is.
Alright. So,
as we head out, not like right outside the gates or anything. No.
Are there pirates waiting at the front gate for us?
As you guys head to the gates, you know, your day spent talking to the stale people wandering around the city. It's a very large city, so it's getting a little bit darker outside. You know, it's probably getting into mid-afternoon, so the sun is setting in the distance. And you leave the main gate and start heading down the path, and after about, you know, half an hour or so, I imagine you're probably comfortable to start hacking down some of this grass.
Now, can I just say, can we actually collect this wheat at the very edge? Like, can we get as far away from the city before nightfall? And then we can always get some near when we're, like, I just don't want to spend the night too close to here.
Sure.
Because if anyone gets wind that we've left, oh, that's right, we left, we didn't leave all together too, right?
Yeah, we would have left in groups.
Right. Because I was also going to quickly just see about buying a heavier blanket. Or whether it's like a fur blanket or some wool or something, but I just need a warmer blanket and probably better boots.
Question for the DM. While we were waiting for that 10-day, after I picked up those extra traps,
yep.
Would we have had any luck trapping anything?
Oh, yeah.
Like any you've caught bigger game?
Yep. Yeah, you got at least one, like, large elk.
Ooh.
So lots of meat from it.
Okay.
And a pelt if you want it.
Yeah. And was it a male?
Yep.
And I want the antlers, too.
Yeah, 100%. All right. Yeah, so you guys managed to get that. Almagar, you managed to get a fur, like a heavy fur blanket as well, if you so wish. It'll set you back 5 silver.
Almagar, you want an elk blanket? Ah?
Ooh, that would be great. I'm sure we could fix this up pretty good.
Yeah.
All right, so over that 10-day, you managed to clean and dry out and properly...
Or do you want a deer blanket?
Actually, the elk sounds pretty good. They've got some nice warm fur. Maybe the innkeeper would have let us maybe use some room in the back, like for hanging meat to dry or something. And obviously, yep. Give him something
for
that.
100%. Yeah. He took some of it for clients, but otherwise, yeah.
Yes, absolutely. He can take some for his fee. We get our nice dried meat for our trip.
Yep, 100%. So you guys are managed to do all of that.
Sure. Just roughly for the sake of how much meat, like ration wise, can I write down for that?
I would say 3 days, solid 3 days of rations. For everybody, like the entire group.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
Elk, if large, which this one was, have a lot of meat on them.
Tasty, okay. Too.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm sure we would have enjoyed some of that while we were,
Oh, yeah.
The fresh.
Okay, so you guys continue walking. Now, to get back to the forest edge where Briek is, it's at least... 6 or 7 days of travel. It's a full 10-day back to Briek, so you guys will start this journey. But as you are walking down the road, you notice there is a group of people 10 minutes further down the road. They've lit a fire in the middle of the road, and there's a bunch of them kind of crowded around said fire.
Oh, boy.
But just outside of Aeleas here?
You've been traveling for like a few hours or a couple hours, and you come across this.
Does it look like roughly? Like it looks like 5 or 6 or like a dozen?
Yeah, exactly. 5 or 6, yeah.
5 or 6, okay.
Do they look like just other travelers, or does anything stand out about them?
Hard to tell from this distance. Yeah.
You might have lots of frilly. Yeah. Okay. Sweet. I would assume they've seen us. If we can see them, they can see us, type thing.
Yeah, they look like most of them are facing your direction, for sure.
Okay.
And you can see, it's getting dark out, so you just have some of the star and moonlight, and then their fire they've lit, but it looks like there's some glints off of metal and stuff, so the guys are probably armed.
Okay.
Just keep traveling. They've seen us.
Yeah, just keep going.
Let's just keep going.
It's like this field on fire. No. All this funny.
No. Right.
Yeah, so I would say we should just keep going. Yeah.
So as you walk or keep walking, they actually start approaching you too. They kick out their fire really quickly, dump some water on it, steam rises.
Oh, and my.
They approach you. Soon you're within about 100 feet of them, and you can make them out a little bit clearer. These guys are wearing like kind of a rough leather armor. A couple of them got rapiers at their side. One has this big falchion. And at the forefront is your guys' bald friend with the piercings in his ears. And he says, "Hello, friends. Fancy seeing you on the road here. And what do I see here? Apparently, not only have you done the job, but you've brought him right to me so I can finish it. Worth a map, indeed."
What?
Oh, I'm so glad you brought the map with you, too. That's...
How convenient.
Oh, no. We'll have to go back to Alien tomorrow, but I'm sure you wouldn't mind camping with me and my friends here for a night. We're kind gentlemen.
Huh? Yeah, sure. Yeah. Why not?
Well, I'm afraid your sleep will be a little bit more permanent. then
you. Oh, don't worry, he doesn't sleep.
Oh, really?
Yeah, no.
we may have to rectify that as Tarkin draws.
Alex. Oh, sorry. Oh, shoot. I was gonna just.
No. Go for it. You're not in combat yet. He's just drawn it.
Okay.
He's pointing it at.
Oh yeah, because I was just gonna say the moment they told sleep, like obviously Maple, we all know exactly what's happening, so I'm not gonna wait for them to make the first move.
Yeah.
Just gonna take my two hand axes and just throw it right at him.
Yeah, go for it. Right at Tarkin.
Awesome.
Yeah. Unless, sorry. He looks like the leader, or is there anyone else there?
He's the only one doing talking. The other guy's maybe a little bit more well equipped than him, because he's just wearing his frilly shirt and sword, but yeah, he looks like he's the forefront of these guys.
Okay. So yeah, just the one move, I'll kind of lift the axes out of my up and then they'll be in the air and I'll grab them with my hand and just, you know what I mean, right? Like,
yep, 100%.
All right.
So yeah, you can go ahead and give me two attacks for that.
23 and 24.
Oh yeah, those are both hits.
And I haven't even gotten to rage or anything yet because I'm just like, yeah.
Sorry, I'm loud. Sorry.
We're almost done anyway, right? Yeah. So the first hand axe is 7 points, and the second one is 6 points of damage.
Okay. Alright, so you throw the two axes, he tries to get out of the way of it, and two grazes across one of his shoulders and across his chest as he tries to go sideways. He says, "Oh, come now, I thought we were friends!" And he just goes all serious, he says, "Kill these fuckers." And with that, I need initiative. Alex, what'd you get?
9.
Scott?
15.
And Pi?
23.
And Zena?
6.
Alright, Pythagoras, you're up first.
Oh, shit. Yeah, I guess I'm drawing my rapier.
The red one?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Looking for this, bitches?
All right, baby. Time for the draw some blood. So I'm gonna charge at that guy, the bald dude. Right. I guess Tarkin, right?
Yep.
Let's see. I'm gonna strike him. Fuck yeah. Uh, 25 to hit.
That is definitely a hit.
Swing and a miss.
I'm back, baby. I'm back. Max damage too, yes!
Nice.
14 damage.
Awesome. Alright. Okay. Well, Apai, they clearly want you dead first, so they are going to rush in and attempt to surround you. So Tarkin and there's a total six of them. There's five kind of thugs, so Tarkin and then Tarkin himself. So Tarkin and Tarkin and two of these guys are going to move in on you, Pi, and then the other three are going to move past you, and one each is going to move to Aeleas, Maple, and Alvar. So Tarkin,
okay.
He swipes twice with his blade, and then he comes up with a dagger out of nowhere and just attempts to stab you right in the side. Only the sword connects. Oh, Pi, one slice of the blade connects, and you take 5 points of damage. The other two who have approached also take an opportunity to attack. And
while they're approaching, do these guys look like they're mercenaries for hire, or do they look like they're actual pirates? Like
they look like they fit right in with Tarkin, so they're probably related to him in some way.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean they're probably still work for hire, but of that ilk, right?
Gotcha.
Okay, the other two swing their blades as well. You are fast enough, Pythagoras, to kind of bat them out of the way and stay on your feet. The one comes for you, Almagar. A little hesitant as you just threw those axes. And your armor class is?
18.
All right, so he does manage to connect as he goes for your wrist. And you take 5 points of damage from that. Maple, the one on you, not only does he not hit you, he's rushing towards you so... just like dead set on a purpose that he clearly ignores a large rock on the ground and trips directly over it and just face plants right into the ground and slides towards you and his sword leaves his hand.
Well, that looks like an opportunity.
Wow. Just
kind of right there. We'll wait for your turn to roll around, but there, yes. Okay, for you, Aeleas. Your armor class is...
15.
All right, so he will connect as well with a scimitar, and he takes a slash across your chest, and you take 4 points of damage.
Well, at least it's not the shoulder. It's a good start.
But the slash across your chest starts at the shoulder.
and a hold Almagar, the shoulder is a lot less lethal than a hold of the chest.
Yeah, true.
So he hit my wrist, and now it's feels a little like this, so I'm just gonna go full on frenzied rage and no one smacks me on the wrist.
Alright, so you go into a frenzied rage.
Nobody attacks Pythagoras. Greatest hero in all the lands.
That's right.
and with my great axe, I will swiftly deal with this guy.
Alright. That's a hit.
Which one? Ooh. 12 damage.
Holy crap. Yeah, you come down with your axe, and you just thud, and it sticks further into him than you've ever put an axe into a wooden pole. And... it comes out with just a sickening suction, and he falls forward. You can see his like broken open rib cage.
Now, other than the one that's face planted in front of Maple, who would be the next closest? Like, would
the one on Aeleas?
What Aeleas say? Okay. Yeah. So as soon as I knock this guy down, I'm just going to go straight and just, hit again on the next guy.
Okay.
Is he facing me or is he facing, like...
He's fighting Aeleas right now, yeah. So he's right. Engaged there, slapping swords.
Come on.
Oh no, the swords have touched!
The slapping of swords.
Oh, that's 17 again, the exact same rule.
Alright, so that's definitely a hit.
Ooh. 15 damage on this guy.
Oh, so you plant your axe in his chest, pull it out, this gaping wound, and then you go straight for the other guy, and you take him out at the knee. And the lower half of his leg just separates from his body, and he falls back, and you just plant your axe right into his skull. As he
falls. And I'm just going to let this big laugh, and I'm going to point right at, what's his name?
At Tarkin.
Tarkin, just point right at him. And laugh. In a frenzied laugh, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
This is the kind of like, I'm going to kill you.
You're going to be in so many pieces soon. I can't wait.
You should have dropped the map. I wanted to steal that map off of bastards.
All right, Aeleas, so what would you like to do? So the guy that you're just like, you're fighting, engaging with swords, all of a sudden, clunk!
I'm covered in more
just
blood than blood I've ever
sprayed. Yeah.
Even after you've died, this is more blood on you than you've ever
had. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'll go for one of the guys attacking Pythagoras.
Okay.
This guy's not easy.
Not Tarkin, but just one of the dogs.
All right, so you... Are you attacking with your swords or are you firing?
With my swords.
Okay, so run forward with swords. Okay.
Yeah, cool. We're all close and.
100%. Yeah. Cool.
Let's get two up. Eight and nine. I can't see. There's so much blood in my eyes.
You're just like so. You're so pumped up from the rage that Almagar's in that you just start also trying to emulate his flurried attacks, and it just doesn't go as well. The guy sees you at the last minute and puts up his sword and just barely deflects your blades as they came in. Death blows. All right.
Oh, yeah, Necromancer. Suck him!
They're just like so taken aback by his battle. Actually, he doesn't really seem to care. He just eats some of the golden patch.
Yeah, I'll feed him some of these guys later.
What happened with the last guy?
Your guy is still lying on the ground. The other two are dead, and Aeleas ran forward to go fight with Isaac.
Okay, yeah.
I forgot to wipe the blood out of my eyes.
Even better. I'm gonna grab my long sword, and I'm gonna, try and stab the guy while he's laying on the ground there.
All right. And you, sir, you do get advantage on this as well because he's prone.
Good, because that one is.
That's much better.
Twenty
to hit.
Oh
yeah. Okay. I'm an idiot. For 7 damage, because I didn't go into rage.
That's okay. Like, you're just not threatened enough.
Yeah.
Pincushion.
Smack him on the head.
However, because of the position he's on the ground, 7's enough. You just go right into the back of his neck.
And before I'll finish him, and then I want to grab his weapon off the ground.
Sure.
And can I still move?
Yeah, you can move as part of grabbing the weapon off the ground, for sure.
Okay. I will go, I guess, to the nearest guy that's not Tarkin.
Okay. Alright. So there's two that are not Tarkin that are also fighting Pythagoras. Aeleas is on one, and there's one that nobody else is fighting. So do you want to go to that guy?
Yeah, I'll go to that one then.
Okay. Alright.
And what weapon did I pick up?
This guy was carrying a scimitar.
Is that one?
It is, yeah.
Is it a simple or martial weapon?
It is.
Awesome. Yeah, okay.
Partially simple.
I can use it.
Because I can use it too.
To pick up, like, what the fuck is this?
Strange.
Do I stab or?
Yeah.
All right. So, Pythagoras, what would you like to do?
Keep attacking Tarkin.
All right.
Fuck yeah. Got my rapier back.
Careful, these ones bleed really, really...
20.
It's like, yeah. Sacks full of blood. Yeah, that is a hit.
They bleed more than normal.
Max damage again, 14.
Nice.
Oh, wow.
Got her back. Just savoring this moment, stabbing him with my rapier.
Yeah, you're just like, just beautifully working the sword with this. Your rapier just ching, slash. Ching, slash.
So much lighter than that stupid short sword.
Yeah. All right, he's going to try and emulate this desperately. He's still fighting with his sword in one hand and a dagger in the other.
Hole in each shoulder? Well, just a little paper cut.
Petty dodge thrust! You shall be caught in twine!
All right, so he takes the two swipes with the sword. You deflect both, but he does get a blow with his dagger in. And you take 4 points of damage from that.
I'm dead.
He's like got some blood coming out of his mouth, and he's like, ready to give up yet, you scum?
Sister.
Never!
I hope you have some backup coming out of the field somewhere, because... You're not really putting up much of a fight there.
Should have given them some maps.
Should have just sold us a map for a decent price to begin with. You're looking for an advance. Now who's going to make maps?
True.
Who's going to carry on the family tradition?
I can do it. Well, not family tradition, but...
All right, so the one that is... fighting you there, Aeleas, he does land a blow for 3 points of damage. And the other fighting you, Maple, does not even get close. You don't even have to deflect it with your weapons. You just dodge out of the way and continue engaging with them. All right, Almagar.
Three dead sailors
sitting at your feet.
Okay. How many are actually attacking Pythagoras right now? Like, there's
only,
all three.
Now only Tarkin. The other two are occupied with Aeleas and Pippin.
Okay, I'm not sure if Pythagoras bought this kill, or... How bad does he look? Like, is he... Does he...
Pythagoras looks like he's just dominating the guy.
Okay.
Yeah, like, none of these guys look like they have a chance.
I'm going to walk over, like take my turn to walk kind of past Pythagoras, or I say up to beside Pythagoras. Forget it. I'm going to still walk up and just slash his leg.
Okay.
Not trying to kill him, just let's get him on the ground, maybe.
Yeah, go ahead.
Have a few words. That way, Pyth can finish him off. Yeah. Or not. Wow, boy, that's what I get for getting so cocky. That would be 10 to hit.
Nope. Swing and a miss.
So I missed your walker, yeah. So they shall still talk then. Yeah.
However, there is now a screaming barbarian behind him.
He's slightly startled.
Yeah.
So I'll just make it look like, let me at him.
Alright, Aeleas.
We're gonna try the whole attack thing again. I think I got some of the blood on my eyes. All right. So
just quickly wiping it away as you're fighting.
Yeah. That's a nat 20.
Nice! Critical hit. Alright.
That'll do. Oh, I missed, but it's a 6.
Yeah, definitely missed. But nat 20, so you roll weapon damage twice, then add your bonus once.
Cool.
Eight. Nice. Okay. You thrust your blade right into his gut. And as you pull it out, he's got pieces of it coming out of his stomach. And he just tries to hold it in, but it collapses to the ground.
Excellent, excellent.
All right. Maple.
Okay, so I'm going to...
Finish him.
I want to use both weapons to attack this guy.
Sure.
So
so what you do is you make... essentially, you're making, like, your longsword attack twice.
Oh, Okay.
But the damage on your scimitar will just be 1d6, and there's no other bonus to it.
Okay. So for the first attack, then, I'll do my longsword.
Okay.
That would be a crit fail.
Wow, I think we all got a little cocky there.
Stick with the spear, man. Gotta stick with the spear.
I'm not using my spears on him. They're not worthy enough to get hit with the silver.
Ooh.
You're just not used to using two weapons at the same time, or if you are, you're just a little rusty. And as you like try and do this very fancy move,
whoa,
long story right out of your hand. And it just flies by Almagar's head. And then because it flies by Almagar's head, also flies by Pythagoras' head. And, and then plants in the ground behind.
His maple fighting again.
Alright, you can go ahead and make the attack with your scimitar.
That's progress, no shoulders.
Natural 20!
Yeah!
Yeah! There we go! Alright. So, that's awesome. So just 2d6 for that.
So that was all just for show, to make them look like we were like a bunch of incompetent big boots or something.
Oh, whoops. Fuck you!
No bonuses, because it's your offhand weapon, so it's just the two die rolls.
Two damage.
Two? Okay. Alright, so you struggle to recover from that one. It's like, oh. And you just watch as it almost kills someone. And then you're just like, right, I need to try and kill this guy. And then you get in a small slash across his arm.
You're still not sure how to use a scimitar, so you actually slap him with it.
Break his nose? Oh god, what are you doing? Alright.
That would be better if you just killed me.
I'm gonna keep going. Aw, oh, two.
Okay.
Well, eight.
Alright.
Actually,
so,
yeah. Action surge.
Yeah, alright.
Always forget about that shit.
Come on, baby. Not much better. 13?
13 is not enough, no. You almost get a blow, and then he just barely deflects the blade. The guy you're fighting, Maple, regardless of you throwing your sword, just is terrified, clearly. He's just gonna try and jut into the golden grass beside where you guys are off the road there. You can go ahead and take attack opportunity with the scimitar.
Sure.
Or we can just meet up with him down the road later and you can join our team. Right, Aeleas?
I've never seen that happen before.
Would that be strength to the scimitar?
Yeah, you can add. Well, you can add strength or dex, whatever you prefer, because it's a finesse weapon.
22 to hit.
Oh yeah, that's a hit.
5 damage.
Nice.
Obviously,
all
he's
right.
Not getting paid enough to fight this battle.
As he turns to run, you just slash down his back, and he collapses forward into the grass. What a mess. Okay.
And I'll turn to the other two fighting.
All right. Tarkin is actually the only one left. Aeleas was able to gut his guy as well.
Okay,
so
Tarkin
looks at the situation and just drops his dagger and his sword. And his hands are up in the air and he goes, okay, I'm sorry. Please don't kill me. I'll pretend I never saw you. I will say that you were not in the city. Come on, please.
Maps. And your coin.
He already dropped his weapons, right?
Yeah.
So I'm just going to go walk up. I'm just going to basically grab both of his arms, put him behind his back, and then we can search him and take his coins.
Right, so as he's like kind of hesitantly searching for it, you just grab his arms. He doesn't put up any of a fight. He just says, oh, please don't kill me. I'm just doing a job. Please don't kill me. I want to write that book you told me to write.
And you still should. I mean,
I think you should.
That was a good idea.
And believe me, I'll
include
a passage.
Make sure you put us in as the heroes.
Yeah. Oh, of course. You guys were great, defeated evil bandits, the whole works. Yeah.
Okay,
and with that, I go and pick up my longsword that I threw.
Um, who? Oh, sorry. I'm holding him. Who is actually going through his pockets and everything? Pythagoras, would you like to like actually loot him as I hold him?
Yeah.
And also, this whole thing is between you and Pythagoras. So this is, you know, Pythagoras wants to kill you. He'll kill you. Wants to let you go. Let you go. It's up to him.
Please, Pythagoras, I promise I'll tell them that you were never in Aeleoth. I'll tell them that I saw you somewhere else, if you'd like, if it's more convenient. Just whatever. Whatever you want.
Yeah. So what does he have?
Alright, so he's got a pretty hefty coin pouch. So this guy thought enough of himself that he's not too worried about it getting stolen. So yeah, there's a big pouch like this big that's just full of gold, silver.
Oh, payday.
Nice. So... that's good.
I'll toss that to whoever's... Oh, yeah, you're holding... Or Almagar's holding him, right?
Yeah.
So I'll toss it to Maple. I guess she's closest.
Yeah. Or Mary Alice.
Right. Yeah. Toss it to the treasurer.
The other bodies.
Okay. And while this is going on.
Sure. He's got several nice golden root and things, little gems in his ear.
Yeah, I'll take those.
Just pop, pop, pop. Or are you actually gonna?
I'll pop all of them except one. Except one.
All right. So he's like, ah. and then aside from that, he doesn't have a whole lot on him. He has two rings, one of which looks fairly expensive. It looks like it's gold and has a large red ruby in it.
Yoink.
And then apparently the guy might have actually thought that you guys were scummy enough to hand over Pythagoras, because he does have a map on him. Now, it's just the small map that is of this area, but it still gives you some more detail than the map that I had shown you guys previously. So I'll fill that out and I'll give you guys a copy of that. So it gives you a little bit more of the area. But he thought that you guys were actually going to hand him over. So... he says, see, I even brought the map. Well, I'm out of my word. I would have given it to you if you'd turned him over. I mean, that would have been the wrong choice. Don't be wrong. That would have been the wrong choice. But see, all yours. All yours.
How many earrings did I get off?
You got four.
What were his weapons?
He had a short sword and a dagger.
Nicer short sword than the one you have?
Is it? Yeah, the short sword is pretty average quality. The dagger, however, is quite nice and actually has a large polished stone embedded in the bottom of it.
The dagger?
It has some like gold filigree around the hilt as well.
Definitely take that. Alright, let's just...
I guess I'm still raging, too.
Just rip his hands out of his sockets.
Well, Tarkin, today's your lucky day. And I look to Almagar and I go, let him go. And when he has his back turned, I want to try and cast a spell on him. Will it work?
Right. Well,
so
you let him go, Almagar?
This is not my fight. This is
okay. So he like rubs his shoulders and then just kind of looks at you guys and realizes that you're just letting him go, and he just starts running down the road. Yeah, you can go ahead and try and cast a spell. What spell would you like to cast?
It's called Sacred Flame. I'm gonna call it Sacred Spark because it's my thing. I'm all thunder. But
yeah, for sure.
So he has to roll a Dexterity save 12.
Okay.
Or he just takes damage.
Certainly did not get that. In fact, it's a critical failure.
So the way I'm going to cast a spell is I'm going to snap my finger and a spark of electricity will come out and it'll shoot him in the ass and light his ass on fire. So I'll just be like,
okay. All right.
But before I do that, I'm going to go, hey, tell Rowan Kellethan you can't start a fire without a spark.
Oh, man.
And then.
Yeah!
So you snap your fingers, you feel the void within you fill, and you can feel the power cascade from you to your fingertips, and it sparks, and this thing juts out, and his ass is on fire, and he's like, ah! As he runs, he's just rolling around in the grass.
Takes
and yeah, that's where we will leave it for the night.